approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a former Drug Enforcement Administration agent was sentenced to 78 months in prison on Monday for stealing bitcoins during the government's investigation of Silk Road and for secretly soliciting payments from the operator of the online black market for information on its probe. Carl Force admitted to charges of extortion, money laundering, and obstruction of justice. In a San Francisco federal court on Monday, U.S. District Judge Richard Seaborg said the scope of his betrayal was breathtaking. Silk Road operated for more than 2 years until it was shut down in October 2013. Ross Ulbricht, Silk Road's creator, who authorities say used the alias Dread Pirate Roberts, was sentenced to life in prison in May after a federal jury in Manhattan found him guilty of several charges, including distributing drugs through the internet. Prosecutors also reached a plea agreement with Sean Bridges, a former Secret Service agent, who was charged along with Force in March with stealing Bitcoin during the investigation that led to Ulbricht's conviction. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Millions of Americans are irrationally feared dead following a train derailment near Wilmington, Delaware.
Less than 200 people were aboard the train, but because no names have been released yet, countless more are being imagined trapped inside the wreckage by worried parents and overly anxious friends.
And the list of imagined victims is growing by the minute. From brothers-in-law who live in Delaware, who usually drive but could possibly have been on that train, to friends who went to Delaware on a business trip and may have been next to the tracks for some reason when the train derailed.
And sadly, we're getting reports that even those who have never been to Delaware are now also among those irrationally thought killed.
Oh, and we are just now getting word from Homeland Security that they're now warning people their fears may spiral into a wholly new fear that their loved ones never existed at all and are just byproducts of a drug-induced lucid dream in which their consciousness is currently imprisoned.
Such a shame, since this is reality.
There is nothing beyond this to believe otherwise. It would be folly.
This is the Onion News Network.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and we've got Skype as well. Skype username's lrn.fm. But I wanted to start with the show, or start the show out with the story we just did not discuss last night, but we teased it as though we would. With you in the studio tonight, you have me, Ian.
And Tarrin P. Lupo, back from the dead.
And Mark.
Tarrin, you had pneumonia over the last couple of weeks, so glad to see you back
behind
the mic.
Not so fun. But,
you sound good, too.
Thank you. It makes your voice a little more deep.
Does
like, it?
It
gives you a little Sulu going on.
A little Barry White.
Oh, man, I love Barry.
Photographyisnotacrime.com is reporting. Carlos Miller, great blog, by the way. Photographyisnotacrime.com. A Missouri cop with an oral fixation for penis. Was able to convince 60 straight men to come to his home for fellatio after placing an ad on Craigslist. Chesterfield police officer David Cerna would pose as a woman online, sending men a photo of a woman, telling them that she wanted to perform oral sex on them. The men would get aroused and make arrangements to meet the woman at her home, only to show up and learn that she was shy and didn't want to show her face.
Oh, man.
So, the men would stick their penis through a hole in the door as Cerna kneeled on the other side, performing oral sex on them.
What?
60 men. You're not, are you really that shocked, Tarrin?
Yeah, I mean,
come on.
I mean, there would be a glory hole set up in someone's house.
I'm shocked
I'd
that
be
one
a little
actually
suspicious.
Exists. I'm sorry.
Wait, you're shocked that a glory hole exists?
No. Yeah, I guess I am.
What, do you think these are the things of legends?
Yeah, indeed I did.
No.
I can also say that I'm shocked that somebody would be so foolish as to stick a part of themselves through one.
Well, you know, horny guys, Mark, they'll do just about anything to get their rocks off.
Are you telling me that that 60 guys fell for this?
60 men in 18 months fell for this ruse. The Missouri cop would record the sex acts on video and then post them online on a gay porn website that he ran.
I'm pretty sure that part is what got him in trouble.
Ah.
Well, just you wait. There's more to this story. And it's the second portion that things get pretty awful. Because as far as so far in the story here, there's really nothing that's illegal about this, right? You know, he invited these people. Yeah, sure, he masqueraded as a woman. That's sort of fraudulent. But it's the internet. People do that stuff all the time. So, you know, if you want to go and have your unit fellatioed and you don't want to check and see who's doing the job first, if you really don't care that much, because like you said, Mark, why would somebody just stick their thing through that hole? It could be cut off, for instance, on the other side. You know, you get what you get.
Okay, so here's what I want to know.
Buyer beware.
How did the conversation go at the door? Like, there's a hole in the door.
I don't want to show my face. Stick it through.
I'm just not fooled by that voice.
And maybe he was really good at a female voice.
He would have
to
be.
Yeah. So, you know, as far as I'm concerned, okay, yeah, it's a little fraudulent, but whatever. They got what they came for.
I almost feel this. It's fraudulent, but I have a difficult time feeling bad for somebody who just goes and puts any old part through a hole in the wall.
Right. They should be feeling grateful that it wasn't, you know, yanked or torn off or cut off or something like that. It could have been a lot worse.
Things went remarkably well.
Yeah. But I think it's funny that you are surprised that the glory hole
is a rare new breed of success,
is a thing that actually exists.
All right, that, just to repeat here, the police officer actually had it on his front door, the glory hole.
I don't
so
know
they
where the door
in?
Was. That's not real clear.
I mean, did they even get in the house?
I don't know.
Maybe he let him.
Maybe he let him in the back porch or something like that.
You would hope that there was another door, right? Like it wasn't just some guy like really close to a front door. What is that guy so
it
close to?
It sounds like they didn't get in the house. It sounds like they were stuck on the porch.
They were stuck someplace. Pinned there, as it were.
This is a great story.
It is a great story. Congratulations. You're gay.
If you want to share your thoughts with us here, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You know, you really shouldn't be surprised. Some of them are just so desperate to get their rocks off. They will do almost anything. And you know what I think would be really interesting to know is, and we don't know this, but maybe the man who's now been arrested, and we'll tell you what he was arrested for here in a moment. It doesn't have to do with this. Maybe he could tell us how many of the people came to the house, were presented with the idea that they should stick their penis through the hole in the door for fellatio purposes, and then left. What portion of them decided, nope, not going to do this, turn around and left? I bet you the majority of them went for it because they were already there. They're, you know, ready to go. They got this picture of the woman in their mind, and well, that's good enough.
Who is the one that... okay.
You drove across town.
Who gave the 60 people number?
I don't know.
Because that's what matters.
Well, he put it up online so they could have counted the videos.
Okay, so at that point, that means 60 of the 60 did it. We don't know how many turned around.
Yeah, we don't know.
But, I mean, in the day and age of To Catch a Predator, you know, I would definitely think twice before I just had random sex off a Craigslist ad. I mean, you don't know what you're putting
through
that
hole.
Indeed,
you don't.
I expect Chris Hansen to pop out into the kitchen or a bush and tackle me.
What period of time did these videos go up over?
Not clear. Okay. Well, I mean, it does say they were over 18 months, but you know, I don't know if he put them all up at once or you know, over time. Probably over time.
18 months sounds like the answer to the question.
60 men in 18 months. The Missouri cop. Okay, so here's the bad part of the story. He would also arrest boys and transport them to the police station, where he would take them into a back room, frisk them thoroughly, including fondling their genitals, then expose their genitals so they could be recorded by a secret camera.
Oh, man.
And if that didn't keep him busy enough, Cerna also set up a video camera in the bathroom of a local gas station to provide more material for his website.
Seems like this guy felt invincible.
Well, that's probably the way a lot of the cops feel. And that's what led to his arrest after a local television reporter began investigating a secret camera that was found in the Mobile on the Run gas station. The reporter, Chris Hayes from Fox 2, then informed police about the camera, who began investigating, tracking it to their own fellow officer. Officer Serna, who had been on the force for 6 years, was arrested and fired. And through the investigation, police found the videos of the minors, as well as of the men who fell for the fellatio through the door ploy. He's now facing a litany of charges, including invasion of privacy charges related to the videos from the Craigslist hookups. Now, that's a surprise. I'm not sure how that's an invasion of privacy. If you pull down your pants and stick your penis through a hole in a door on somebody else's property, I think you get what's coming to you.
Well, at that point, if you...
so to speak.
If you're fondling minors, you don't have an opportunity to fight the charges. Do you know what I mean?
I see what you're saying.
At that point, they can pile anything they want on you.
You're pretty much dead if there's minors involved.
But I agree, if you stick a bare naked part through a door, that it may be videotaped. Sure.
Serna did plead guilty to the invasion of privacy charges, interestingly, and apparently the trial that the trial for the sexual exploitation charges of minors will be separate. So maybe he could have not taken the plea on that, Mark. They've got two separate trials here for this guy.
I don't know.
All right, okay. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, yeah, not a good guy, not a good story, but it sure was funny in the beginning. Let's go to Doug, listening in Chicago. Doug, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello.
Well, yeah, you had a guy on who called in a day ago claiming that, you know, we need to quit having people on that or quit promoting people, libertarian people who burn the American flag and, you know, to bring more people into the party. My feeling on it can be that the party, Libertarian Party, can be about individual freedom, liberty, and private property. If you don't get that, you don't belong in the Libertarian Party. I mean, the guy acted genuine. He acted like a good guy. Maybe he might have been trying to do a good thing. But, you know, where do we end it here? Okay, there are a lot of people that are offended by making marijuana and pot legal. Maybe we shouldn't promote that in the Libertarian Party either. Now, I mean, we got to quit with the I'm offended, therefore we should not do that. You know, if you don't get individual liberty and freedom, you don't belong in the party, then, in my opinion, you know?
I see where you're coming from on that, Doug. Stand by. We can continue the discussion here because this is one of the big issues among libertarians. Is should people, you know, should the Libertarian Party or the libertarians in general be a big tent group? And we'll see what Tarrin and Mark have to say about it here. And you can share your thoughts as well. It's Free Talk Live.
Olive is a yellow lab, 6 years old, full of energy. But, oh, man, Olive was suffering, to use a word, like a dog. She was itching, she was scratching, she was licking. 24 hours a day, she was shedding all the time. And it drove my wife crazy because she had to vacuum the house a couple times a day. So I'm going up the expressway, and the radio commercial comes on.
Petey stopped eating. All his hair fell out. Mounds and mounds of fur. Our hairballs have hairballs.
And I almost drove off the road because I thought this person on the radio commercial was living with my dog, Olive. And I called my wife. I said, dear, you got to check out this product called Dynavite. Go to DINOVITE.com. So we started Olive on the Dynavite. In about 6 weeks, she almost has entirely stopped itching, scratching, stopped licking herself. Most of the hair has grown back under her belly. Unexpectedly, her coat has become smooth and shiny, almost like it was when she was a newborn pup. Olive is happy, and my wife is probably the happiest person because the house is cleaner. 859-428-1000. DINOVITE.com.
DINOVITE.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then, too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Silvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, Tech Guru Brian Sovereign, Cop Blocker J.P. Freeman, New Mover Dr. Tarrin Lupo, Longtime Political Activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand Minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
Help get LRN.fm into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype. Skype username here tonight is lrn.fm. You want to save big time over at Amazon? Here's how you do it. I mean, already Amazon's got great prices and a huge selection. You can go to saveatpurse.com. That's saveatpurse.com, saveatpurse.com. You'll save 20% on average. And I've personally never saved less than 20%. I've saved 30%, 40%, and various different numbers in between those 20 to 40%. So you can save quite a bit. The catch is you've got to have Bitcoin to do it. So go to saveatpurse.com. That's saveatpurse.com and get started there. It's easy to watch the intro video. And if you don't have Bitcoin yet, that's okay. You can still go to saveatpurse.com and sign up for an account and then get your Bitcoin and get started at saveatpurse.com. Doug is on the line in Chicago. Doug, you were saying that you think that libertarians should be, I guess, more choosy about who they allow to apply that term to themselves. Is that right? I don't want to put words in your mouth. What were you saying?
Well, no, I don't think that we need to allow people in, though, that, you know, are going to ruin what we are, our foundation. You know, I mean, the gentleman that called in, he deeply had been offended by the burning of the American flag. I'm not going to lie, I'm not offended by the burning of the American flag, but I had plenty in my life that I'm offended by. I had a guy down the block from me who tore down a 50-foot tall, beautiful willow tree. You know, I thought that it had been very bad for the neighborhood. But I'm not up in my neighborhood getting a petition together and petitioning the mayor and my local alderman to make a law where you have to have government approval before you can tear down a tree in your yard, like they're doing more often around the country. People do not get individual freedom, liberty, and private property. And if you don't get that, then you really don't belong in the libertarian category. You know, I mean, you have the Republican and the Democratic Party for that. They are the mob rule. They are the anti-liberty. They are the anti-freedom. They are the anti-private property. You know, join one of them. But to bend to our very foundation, to what we are about, for the fact that we need to try and get more people in, well, why even bother then?
I mean, so is this in reference to anything specific, like, let's say, Rand Paul or Gary Johnson, some of these folks who aren't really libertarians but are touted as such by many libertarians?
No, the gentleman that called had been Tyler, I think had been the name of the guy, and he called in and he talked about how we need to prevent people from coming into the Libertarian Party that are doing a lot of crap, like burning the American flag, mm-hmm. and you're turning people off in the military from joining the Libertarian Party by doing that. Well, when I hear that, I automatically want to go out, get an American flag,
and burn it.
And get my GoPro camera and tell everybody I'm Doug the Libertarian and I'm burning the American flag. I mean, to tell people you're offended and therefore you shouldn't do it, you're not being true to a true libertarian.
Well, I think the guy was talking about prudence, right? Like he was talking about disassociation, not letting people into a party, but sort of as a libertarian, disassociating yourself with people that spread the message poorly. And, you know, like I would say that flag burning has rarely been done properly, especially United States flag burning. I haven't seen a good, convincing, arousing flag burning where I've said, you know what, this has helped promote prosperity and human freedom. It mostly just seems like angry people, doing their thing. So I get where he's coming from. I don't know that I'm ready to entirely just shun somebody because they do it, but
yeah, I think it's okay to give somebody feedback on their activism. I mean, if you think something could have been done better regarding the burning the flag, I think it's completely legitimate to give that person some feedback. But to boot somebody out of a movement over differences of opinion on what's an effective form of activism, I agree that we don't need to have that that kind of thing going on.
I can't truly agree with you on it completely, Mark. I mean, if you give the people leverage that are anti-freedom, anti-liberty, that are, well, you should not be burning the American flag, you should not be doing it, we need a law, or you shouldn't be doing it. If you give them leverage, you continue to erode that line. You have that line moved over and over and over. Well, I'm offended by that, therefore, we need a law on that. And another group will come up, well, I'm offended on that particular issue, we need to have a law on that. Before you know it, we are where we are today. You know, you have law upon law. I mean, you know, and not for individual liberty and freedom, not to protect individual liberty and freedom. We have law now for the fact that we have people that are offended. You can't have that.
Everybody's offended by something. And I think those people need to be approached on what it is they're offended by and have, some opportunity to talk to people. And I feel like, you know, there's certain acts that shut off the lines of communication. One of those acts is the flag burning. For instance, there was a guy who burned a flag here on Keynes and Central Square some years ago. And now pretty much every time I see a meme about flag burning, it's a picture of this guy. He's actually become an argument against what he was trying to do in the first place. His activism was quite literally counterproductive. As counterproductive as it could possibly be, because people only see a still shot of his activism. They never get to hear that, oh, he didn't just burn a U.S. flag. He burned a U.N. flag, a U.S. flag, and a New Hampshire flag all at once. Mm-hmm. They see that U.S. flag going up, and, you know, that's his thing. And, he happens to be he's a white kid doing it as opposed to some Arab or something. That just gives them adds fuel to the fire.
Yeah, I hope that I mean, you made your point on it. I hope that I made my point on it.
Thank you.
Is it still worthwhile activism at this point? I mean,
But if somebody does it, I think that it's worth promoting. I think it's interesting, and it's activism that can get people talking. I mean, I understand where Mark's coming from, but you know, in the case of the flag burning you're mentioning, he wasn't arrested for it or anything like that, and there really wasn't even that much as far as people yelling at him in real life for doing it. It was actually a relatively quiet, successful event when it happened. Doug, I think that, you know, the fact is there are always going to be these libertarians who are super critical of other libertarians' activism and don't do very much activism on their own, and they're just going to, you know, be loudmouths about it, and that's just part and parcel of the process of doing things that, you know, that have an impact, doing things that people consider.
Flag burning is not an impact. Flag burning is just, it just throws, it's just a big, it's a macho flash.
If it gets people talking, then it had an impact, and it did. There are things that are offensive, and some things are more offensive than others. Like I said, it's nothing I choose from my own activism, but other people say that I do terrible activism as well, and that I'm ruining the movement with my activism. And you know,
usually
I think
what
need,
they say is that you have poor judgment. I mean, I hear that over
need,
and over again.
Whatever. I've also been told I've been ruining the movement on multiple occasions.
Yes, but that's what they mean. You ruin the movement by supporting people through your poor judgment.
No, they're talking about my own activism, that I'm ruining the movement with that. And, you know, I think we just need the radicals. We need the people who are willing to go out there and do the, you know, the hardcore principled activism and make no apologies for it. And then the, you know, the kind of the apologists, if you will, the people who are criticizing it, then they'll look more reasonable, I guess. And there are always going to be those people in the middle. Doug?
You have to agree with what the individual will be doing to agree with the liberty and the freedom involved with it.
Thanks, Doug, for your call tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Flag burning? Offensive activism? Should it stop? It's Free Talk Live.
My dad was 59 when he collapsed from a heart attack late last year. Just this past August was when we spread his ashes on the St. Croix River. I loved my dad, but boy was he stubborn. He hadn't been to the doctor in over 25 years. His excuse? He simply couldn't afford it. He wasn't a rich man by any means. At less than $107 per month, libertyoncall.org would have been the perfect alternative for my father. Don't wait. Go to libertyoncall.org right now, for not just your sake, but for the sake of your loved ones. Again, that's libertyoncall.org.
Hi, I'm Dr. Sam Nussbaum with the Anthem Foundation. Premature birth is the leading cause of death of babies and disabilities for children. That's why we support the March of Dimes to help mothers have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Join us in supporting cutting-edge research, treatment and outreach to help moms during their pregnancy and give every baby a healthy start in life. Learn how you can help at marchofdimes.org.
The Onion looks back at this week in history. On July 17th, 1980, Ronald Reagan accepted the nomination for president at the Republican National Convention in Detroit and delivered a speech in which he boldly promised that during his presidency, someone would body slam Andre the Giant. While admitting that the road would be long and hard and that it might take as long as 7 years and two WrestleManias to get there, the former California governor vowed that under his administration, somebody, perhaps Ricky the Dragon Steamboat or a hulked-up Hulk Hogan, would grab hold of the 500-pound behemoth and send his massive body smashing to the mat. The Republican nominee also went on to promise that by the end of his first term, Joni would marry Chachi, hair metal would achieve mainstream airplay, and Shelley Long would successfully make the leap from television to film.
This is the Onion News Network.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
Yeah!
Talk Live. Join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Hey, did you hear that the CIA director, the CIA chief, had his email hacked by some kid?
AOL account.
By a teenager.
Did he really have an AOL? He bet he did.
A teenage hacker broke into John Brennan's email account. And, well, there's some interesting things that are in there. Apparently WikiLeaks.
I bet there are.
WikiLeaks has now come into the possession of the contents of CIA Chief John Brennan's email account.
And I'm sure they're guarding it vigilantly.
WikiLeaks actually releases things, so they don't really guard things.
We'll
tell you more about that here in moments. Not everybody listening, Mark, may be aware of what WikiLeaks is, so it's important to inform people.
Excellent. We've given them an opportunity to find out.
855-450-3733. Coming up in 1 week. Are you flying out Wednesday, Mark, to Vegas?
Wednesday, yep. Flying out to Las Vegas.
1 week from today.
The first ever remote broadcast of Free Talk Live from Las Vegas at the D Hotel. And you can go get your tickets at bitcoininvestor.com. It's October the 29th and 30th at the D Hotel. And there's going to be lots of speakers for the Bitcoin Investor Conference, including Trace Mayer, Dr. Stephanie Murphy. Stephen Michaels is putting the event on. He'll be speaking too. Brian Sovereign, Bitcoin Bell, better known as Michelle Seven, Tone Vase, and Edmund C. May. I'm excited for the event. It's going to be a lot of fun. So please come on out and see me. Tickets are $100. You can't beat it. Bitcoininvestor.com.
All right, so you're certainly welcome to comment on the perverted cop story. That's still on the table here, but.
I don't know what there is. What's the issue?
So he got arrested, right, for the first part, which wasn't really illegal. Is it? It's not illegal to film sex, right?
No.
Or without consent?
I don't know. Is that still fall under the whole wiretapping thing?
It's not illegal. It's not legal to record somebody when they're in a bathroom, and that's one of the things they went after him for. It's not legal to certainly molest young boys, which is also something that he did. And they did go after him for some sort of invasion of privacy charge regarding the men who were given fellatio after sticking their penis through a glory hole.
You see, I have a problem. There's one. It's different than, say, picking a gal up at a bar and having, or, you know, picking a guy up at a bar and having videos sort of up in a bedroom. You have a reasonable, a reasonable expectation of privacy if you're going back with somebody to their bedroom to have sex. However, I would say there's a difference between just sticking a body part through a hole in a door and then expecting privacy at that point.
Well, he may have had a camera that was recording the person as well. So there might have been an inside camera recording the sex act, and there might have been an outside camera recording the person outside
the door. It's about reasonable expectation. And I don't know. I think reasonable expectation is now off the table once you talk about a glory hole. You know, I mean, like it's no longer there. If you have chosen to participate in this particular act, participating in the act is not reasonable, so therefore reasonable expectations when committing the act are off the table. I just don't think there is one. You are now the punchline of a joke.
Yeah, imagine all the poor guys that found themselves on the internet. I wonder how many times that happens, you know?
60 at least over 18 months, according to the case.
I'm just hoping the door isn't in, right on the street in the neighborhood. That's what my biggest concern is. Because it would be really odd to be going by and there's somebody really close to a door.
Right, you know, their pants pulled down a little bit.
Right, well, you can zip them, I suppose.
Depending on what you're wearing.
Yeah, depending on what you're wearing. Standing up on the threshold, which would be really strange too, you know? There's often that, 3 or 4 inches of concrete that hangs out of the door.
Not every man is the same height, so some of them might be sort of standing on their tiptoes. Some might be kind of squatting to fit through the hole.
You're assuming that the hole is just one circular hole, but I would imagine
there'd be different holes.
Engineered this might have made, say, a longer hole or something. I don't know.
A longer hole?
Well, a hole isn't necessarily a round thing.
I see what you're saying.
Holes can be all different shapes.
That's true. Generally, when I think of a hole, though, I think of a round shape.
I get where you're coming from. You know, every article you read is going to have something wrong in it. So
that's true.
The expectation that you have that this hole is round may or may not be true.
Well, we need to see the evidence then. We need to see the pictures of the door And that way we'll know more about it.
Yeah.
So RT.com reporting on some big news here. The director of the CIA, John Brennan, his emails have been leaked. And this is from the time period when Brennan worked in the private sector, including reports on Afghanistan and torture, as well as ideas for U.S. policy towards Iran. The emails obtained by a hacker earlier this week were from Brennan's private email account. Well, it's not so private anymore, which the CIA chief appears to have used to work on several intelligence-related projects in 2007 and 2008. The leaked papers include alleged drafts containing discussions about, quote, challenges for the U.S. intelligence community in a post-Cold War and post-9/11 world, unquote, as well as proposals regarding, quote, torture methods, unquote. Hey, wait, don't they say officially that they don't torture in the United States government?
It's enhanced interrogation.
Yeah.
He should not be used. Torture might be easier to spell, but enhanced interrogation is what it is. You should call it what it is.
So here you have him being honest in his private emails about this is actually torture. Among the documents harvested from, and by the way, I should, for listeners just tuning in, if you didn't hear last night's show, this is like email revelations week here so far, because last night we had the emails come from Hillary Clinton's server, which actually were sent by Colin Powell to George W. Bush regarding the George W. Bush and Tony Blair kind of palling up and planning the Iraq War a year in advance from when the Iraq War actually started. At the same time, they were saying publicly that they were looking at diplomatic solutions. So that shows that they were telling lies and that essentially Hillary Clinton was covering up for them. So, you know, they're all on the same side. Now here you go with the CIA director's emails coming out. Who's next? Among the documents harvested include a May 2008 letter from Christopher Bond, the vice chairman of the Senate Select Committee on Intelligence, proposing a way to ban torture while continuing to interrogate, quote, high-value detainees, unquote. Both the director of National Intelligence, the DNI, and CIA director at the time had objected to proposals limiting interrogation methods to the 19 techniques explicitly authorized in the Army Field Manual. Bond wrote, quote, rather than authorizing...
The Army Field Manual has acceptable forms of torture?
Well, they call them interrogation methods.
I see.
You know, as long as, yeah, if you spin it the right way, it's legal.
Quote, rather than authorizing intelligence agencies to use only those techniques that are allowed under the Army Field Manual, I believe the more prudent approach is to preclude the use of specific techniques that are prohibited under the AFM, Bond wrote. This would allow the use of interrogation methods not explicitly authorized in the manual, but still considered acceptable under the Geneva Conventions. Bond lists the methods that should be prohibited. Quote, force, and remember, Bond is some other guy. He's one of these people on this panel, the Senate panel. Quote, forcing the detainee to be naked, perform sexual acts, or pose in a sexual manner, placing hoods or sacks over the head of a detainee and using duct tape over the eyes, applying beatings, electric shock, burns, or similar forms of physical pain, waterboarding using military working dogs, inducing hypothermia or heat injury, conducting mock executions, and depriving the detainee of adequate food, water, or medical care. The note called the conundrum of Iran, which gave recommendations to whoever takes up residence at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue in January of 2009, emphasized the need for negotiations with Tehran. Brennan gave a history of Iran's political development over the centuries, criticized the Islamic Republic for its support of terrorists, but also praised the efforts of Iranian diplomats in negotiations in post-Taliban Afghanistan. The note was written in 2007. When Brennan worked at the Analysis Corporation, an intelligence and analysts firm that he founded. Earlier this week, an American teenage hacker claimed that he'd broken into the personal email accounts of top security officials, with CIA Director Brennan being among them.
You'd think that these folks, I mean, I'm sure that the rules of the CIA are you can't use your personal email account to look at CIA stuff, but these top folks think the rules don't apply to them, that somehow they're safe, and they're not.
Why would they put it in their personal email? That's crazy.
It's crazy.
They would think...
Some of the documents have been posted on Twitter, with edited parts of them reportedly made public by the hacker using the name Kraka. Apart from the CIA's chief email, the teenager claimed to have gained access to Brennan's personal AOL account, which contained the official's own application for top security clearance.
You weren't lying. It really was an AOL account.
Once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, But now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Wednesday, gold is even at $1,174 per ounce, and silver is down 17 cents at $15.77 per ounce. Bitcoin is currently trading at $265. Check out our special on 1 ounce silver spiders, a perfect Halloween treat. And if you've been looking for silver American Eagles, we've lowered the price on those too. Give us a call today at 800-874-9760 or online at rrbi.co.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. You can join us right here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And Tarrin P. Lupo.
And Mark.
And, of course, you can bring up anything that you want. And I wonder, you know, maybe we're just seeing the scratching the surface of the CIA director's emails that have been released. The story coming from RT.com about the teenage hacker calling himself Kraka, who busted into the CIA's email in addition to his personal AOL account. So apparently he got into both the official and the unofficial email accounts of this guy.
Wow.
I'm not real clear on that. That's the way the story makes it sound here on RT, but maybe they've made a mistake.
The story I read, I knew that he had been in the AOL account that the guy had, which to me the best most comic part of this is he had an AOL account, the chief of internet, the chief of intelligence here in this country has an AOL account.
Yeah, apparently it goes back a long ways. He's had this account since before he was the chief of the CIA.
All the people who have AOL accounts are saying that right now. They're saying, but I've had it a long time, and I don't want to try to teach my friends a new account. And, you know, everybody else who had an AOL account had to figure that part out.
If you want to join us here, our toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
I don't know what happened to my Earthlink account, but, I survived the switchover.
The hacktivist group Anonymous also released fragments of several documents, including an undated report by Lewis Tucker, minority staff director at the Senate Select Committee on Intelligence, that was sent to Vice Chairman Bond. Tucker reports he traveled to India, Afghanistan, and Pakistan with four colleagues, visiting a number of cities and officials. He complained the U.S. Central Command in Bagram, Afghanistan, remained strongly unsupportive of the trip at every stage. Tucker wrote, quote, "Everyone we spoke with on the ground in Afghanistan and Pakistan confessed they know of no overall U.S. government strategy for the region. Rather, we observed quality individuals serving judiciously in their own lanes, ungoverned by a coordinated comprehensive strategy," unquote. The group concluded this lack of coordination was the greatest contributor to the U.S. failure to achieve regional stability, urging the development of a comprehensive strategy based clearly on U.S. goals in the region. They also recommended that the U.S. avoid cross-border attacks into federally administered tribal areas of Pakistan, lest they risk alienating the Pakistani government and international opinion. Yeah. So I wouldn't say that a lot of these emails are particularly outrageous, at least the ones that they have cited here in the RT story. But nonetheless, it's kind of an interesting development, and maybe we'll see more coming soon. There were 30,000 emails, apparently, in the Hillary Clinton case, so who knows what's still to come out of that treasure trove. Of course, you can join us here and share your thoughts. 855-450-FREE. That's our toll-free number. Police are warning in Jackson, Mississippi. There's a tweet that they sent out today, or I guess 2 days ago, that says, if your kids get these for Halloween candy, they are not candy. They are the new shapes of ecstasy and can kill kids. The Jackson, Mississippi Police Department had issued a warning for pressed ecstasy pills that could be mistaken for Halloween candy if they ended up in their children's hands, according to FoxNews.com.
Who gives kids $20 ecstasy pills?
We used to... we were kind of jerks, but we used to put in some bullion cubes. You know, those seasoning cubes, because they look like candy. They were wrapped in gold and silver foil. Right. So you would throw it in with a bunch of...
the chicken bullion, right?
Back in the day when you had the taffy that was all foiled out.
I wonder what that was like. It's probably very salty, right?
Yeah, it's just like eating a cube of salt. Because you just throw it in. Great.
While the stories of kids being poisoned or tainted Halloween treats are mostly the stuff of urban legend, it is always a good idea to check your child's candy before letting them eat it. And that's certainly true. I mean, just eating random stuff that's not packaged is probably not the best idea. And of course, you know, the claim here, though, and I think, Mark, you bring up the best objection, and that is that this would be super expensive to do. I mean, even if it was a high-level dealer of ecstasy who was putting these in, you know, he wasn't paying street price of $20 a pill. He's still paying $5 to $10 a pill, depending on...
That's pretty high-level, would be my guess.
It's probably more like mid-level to...
Using logic, all right?
I can't imagine...
go with the scare.
I just can't imagine the scenario where a sane person would say, you know what's a good idea? Handing out ecstasy pills to a bunch of kids.
To children.
Okay, so...
Well, it could be an insane person.
Right, then there's insane people, but insane people are, at this point, I don't know why they stop at ecstasy pills. Why don't they put the razor blades in the apples, or, you know, which I guess has never happened.
Yeah, no kid would eat apples anymore, right?
Right, they're not going to eat
their apples. There's no evidence that ever happened. Right. Yeah.
I mean, you know, why wouldn't they, you know, do a variety of things, like rat poison in candy, or whatever it is that they do? I'm sure you can take rat poison and mix it up with some water and make yourself a nice rat poison slurry and inject it with a hypodermic needle that you can get somewhere into candy and make that candy make somebody very sick.
The old
right?
joke in jail was that you shouldn't eat someone else's root beer barrels because they might have stuck them where the sun don't shine first.
Root beer barrels. Okay. Okay, so Mark's probably old enough. I don't know if Ian was. Did you ever get the homemade treats when you went trick-or-treating?
No, that never happened to me.
We used to get the popcorn balls.
Yeah.
There popcorn were some balls were
homemade,
the ones.
Yeah, homemade treats.
Do you still remember those?
Yeah, I do. And I was able to eat those. We weren't allowed to eat the unwrapped candy sometimes for whatever reason. I'm 44. You know, this happened 30-something years ago, almost 40 years ago. And they would put just sort of unwrapped hardish candies just
in. They would just drop in the peppermint things or whatever. And then we actually had ladies that would make popcorn balls.
Yeah.
And they would stick them in like saran wrap or something. Mm-hmm. But usually you kind of knew where the house was or
I knew the
neighborhood. We went to our neighbors. So I don't know if that stuff happens anymore. I doubt it does.
I lived out in the country, so we had to go in and sort of schlep off of other people's neighborhoods because it wouldn't have made much sense to get into to drive from door to door out where I lived.
I do like how Halloween is like importing children now to the best neighborhoods. That's a thing the last 20, 30 years. That I remember I lived in Savannah right next to the cool neighborhood. And busloads of kids would show up, like a church bus or something.
Yeah.
I don't know. And they would just scour this one neighborhood. And I always wondered.
Weird.
And you would never know who these kids are. You'd never see them again for a year.
So the other check on this story not being true.
Sorry, I railroaded that.
Because this is a fear-mongering post by the police in Mississippi here. So the first check on it not being true is Mark's point that it's super expensive to do this and no one in their right mind would spend that kind of money to give ecstasy pills out to children. But number two, if you've ever tasted MDMA or one of these pills.
Yeah, they're not going to swallow it.
They will, if any child that has a sweet tooth, and pretty much all of them do, is going to spit this thing out. You know, you don't put a piece of candy in
it's
your mouth.
It's medicine, not candy.
You don't put a piece of candy in your mouth and not taste it or chew it, right? Like you want to chew the candy so you can taste how sweet it is or how sour or tangy or whatever and enjoy it. You know, it's not like a dog that's just going to inhale the thing and then, you know, not taste it. Of course, you could argue that.
You could put some aspirins in a roll of Smarties and get away with it?
No, I don't think it would work at all.
If you have ever, by the way, tried to give a dog, many dogs will take they'll have these treats that, you know, say you put peanut butter on or something like that. Or, I'm sorry, the pills you put peanut butter on. Well, they
lick the peanut butter off and drop the pill.
Sure. I mean, many of these dogs, you're not going to get a dog to just snap up a pill without anything on it.
And you're not going to get a kid to snap up a pill either.
I have yet to see the thing in God's green earth that just eats a pill for for the joy of eating a pill.
It's very sour. It's not sour in like a candy kind of way. It's a sour in like this is medicine, poison, kind of nasty, you do not want to eat this kind of way. Any child that that held this in their mouth for a moment, for one second, would spit it out, and they would probably make a big production out of how gross it was.
Well, I've never taken this drug. Do you? I thought ecstasy was ecstasy. Don't they mix it with like juice and stuff and drink
juice.
It?
No, I've never heard of that.
No, maybe no. I'm thinking
of
Molly.
Mushrooms.
Molly water.
No, I've never heard of that one either.
You never heard of Molly water?
Maybe people do that. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me, Tarrin, if people do that. But the typical way you would dose these pills is in pill form. If you're buying Molly, which is street slang for molecular MDMA.
And the chances of it actually being that are very, very slim.
Yeah, well, Molly used to be...
it's not Breaking Bad.
Used to be the term that one used in order to differentiate the garbage from the good stuff.
Correct.
But now it didn't take 5 weeks for somebody to say, hey, you know, I'm going to call my garbage what the people who call the good stuff call it now.
Yeah,
right?
Like
you know, that was it.
But
usually it's a marketing term.
It comes within a gel capsule, so you won't taste it at all, the Molly.
But kids don't just swallow pills out of their trick or treat bags.
It's a ridiculous claim by the police, but I thought I'd share it with you because, well, you need to know why it's not true. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us here. The Uber crackdown continues. We'll tell you how they targeted a grandmother coming up.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Currency is too important a thing to be left in the hands of government bureaucrats, especially when billions of dollars can be created with the swipe of a pen. Overstock.com supports the cryptocurrency movement because it returns the power of an inflation-proof money to the people where it belongs. Did you know that you can use Bitcoin to pay for anything Overstock.com sells while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more? If you support freedom in the cryptocurrency movement, you should support Overstock.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, October 21st, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.85 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,177 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $268. Antiwar.com reports, fresh off his victory in the Canadian elections, Prime Minister-elect Justin Trudeau has confirmed speaking with President Obama and informing him that he would be going through with the campaign promise to withdraw warplanes from the U.S.-led war against the Islamic State. Canada had previously committed fighter jets to the war through March 2016, and while it's unclear the exact date of Trudeau's end, the suggestion is that it will be before that date. He did, however, say that trainers would stay in Iraq, but not the ground troops involved in combat missions. Trudeau has made ending the combat mission against the Islamic State a centerpiece of his campaign, and the Conservatives campaigned heavily against him on this point, including campaign videos using clips of the Islamic State propaganda videos interspersed with Trudeau's comments. Analysts see the election as, in large measure, a referendum on Canadian foreign policy, with outgoing Prime Minister Stephen Harper representing a more aggressive Canadian policy, eagerly participating in U.S.-led adventures the world over, while Trudeau favors a return to a more humanitarian focus. Revelations in recent months that Canadian warplanes were accused of killing dozens of civilians in Iraq and that the Defense Ministry had tried to cover those incidents up likely added to growing opposition to the war, and Trudeau seems to want to make it very clear that his promise to end it wasn't an empty campaign pledge, but a sincere statement of policy. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Wisconsin's Representative Paul Ryan reportedly told Republicans late Tuesday that he is willing to run for House Speaker as long as every caucus approves of him. Ryan, who has previously been mentioned as a potential Speaker candidate, accepted a recruiting pitch for the post by members of his party. Commentators and congressmen have both speculated for weeks as to Ryan's potential candidacy for the House's top leadership post, which will be officially vacated by Ohio Representative John Boehner on October 30th. Boehner, who who has served for nearly 5 years in the post, announced his abrupt resignation almost a month ago. Ryan has earned a lot of political capital among congressional Republicans to succeed Boehner, but he has yet to formally announce his intentions to run. Tuesday, though, he agreed to meet with Tea Party hardliners who had strongly supported Boehner's removal and later a larger group of Republicans. Boehner announced he was stepping aside on September 25th. House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy of California, the House's top Republican leader after Boehner, remained in the race for 10 days, but abruptly dropped out on October 8th.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a former Drug Enforcement Administration agent was sentenced to 78 months in prison on Monday for stealing bitcoins during the government's investigation of Silk Road and for secretly soliciting payments from the operator of the online black market for information on its probe. Carl Force admitted to charges of extortion, money laundering, and obstruction of justice. In a San Francisco federal court on Monday, U.S. District Judge Richard Seaborg said the scope of his betrayal was breathtaking. Silk Road operated for more than 2 years until it was shut down in October 2013. Ross Ulbricht, Silk Road's creator, who authorities say used the alias Dread Pirate Roberts, was sentenced to life in prison in May after a federal jury in Manhattan found him guilty of several charges, including distributing drugs through the internet. Prosecutors also reached a plea agreement with Sean Bridges, a former Secret Service agent, who was charged along with Force in March with stealing Bitcoin during the investigation that led to Ulbricht's conviction. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A majority of Americans are pointing to Friday's tragedy as a clear call for major reforms in everything, or literally anything at all that might prevent acts of horrifying, senseless violence. According to a recent ONN poll, the nation is united in saying that the key to preventing future tragedies is a drastic change in gun control, mental health care, school security, media coverage, violent entertainment, the fragility of the human condition, and really so many other things we probably haven't even thought of yet. Jesus. The Randolph Center for Public Health and Safety also released a statement saying, quote, "If you look at statistics regarding gun violence in the United States, you'll see the recent shooting is a clear cry for any thing at all to please, please be different." In Washington, lawmakers have reached a bipartisan agreement that the U.S. desperately needs tighter firearm restrictions or looser firearm restrictions, or honestly, whatever option just makes these things stop. Do that one.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us on the radio. The toll-free number is 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Joining you in the studio, it's Ian.
And Tarrin P. Lupo.
And Mark.
And also want to let you know about ProXPN. We all use the internet these days, but we really don't get to use it the way it was meant to be used. Anonymous and without oversight. Fortunately, ProXPN is here to solve that. It's a virtual private network, and they encrypt your online data before it gets to your ISP. The ProXPN offers OpenVPN, the gold standard of network encryption, and they have apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and there's Linux support as well, so setup is super easy. Unlike other VPNs, ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever, and they've got more servers now than ever before, giving you greater speed and security. Plus, they've integrated Nonkly.com to mask your emails if you get a premium account. They accept credit card and even Bitcoin. Plus, you can use code FTL50 and get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy the annual account. It can be cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. Use the internet the way it should be used. Go to proxpn.com right now and use code FTL50 to take back the privacy that is your right. It's proxpn.com and code FTL50, as in 50% off. You know, it's
I think probably the biggest thing on social media today has to be Back to the Future Part 2. Oh. Doesn't it? I mean, this thing's everywhere.
The Star Wars preview came out yesterday, Monday Night Football, too.
Yeah. So there's people are buying tickets 2 months in advance. They crashed the ticket selling websites, I heard. Yeah.
I haven't even seen the... I assume it's online, right?
I have not seen it either.
The trailer?
Yeah, we in my house, we put it up on the big TV and watched it three times through, so we definitely saw
it. What's it about? Like, I haven't been following the new Star Wars release. Is it going to be in the future or from Han and Leia or what?
Imagine, don't they have old Han and Leia? And
yep, they've got old Han and Leia. Yep. It appears as though there may be a daughter of Luke and, or I'm sorry, Han and Leia, maybe.
Okay.
That's running around that looks remarkably like Princess Amidalia did. Only, you know, like you cross Anakin and Amidalia together, and you get them. You get this, you know, beautiful young woman.
Wait, weren't Han and Leia brother and sister?
No, that was Luke and Leia.
Oh, okay.
And but good catch. I'm glad you're looking out for the incest, buddy. And
that's allowed in the future, or a long time ago.
A long time ago.
That's fine.
It is a galaxy far, far away. So, you know, it's who am I to say? But yeah, that appears to be it. We don't know. There's another character that's a stormtrooper that appears to get. I think he was a pilot of a TIE fighter. Appears to get separated from his group.
Is this a long trailer?
It's two and a half minutes.
Okay, so full length feature trailer.
Probably 2 minutes and then you know, stuff on the other ends. And then you know, but he's a born warrior and then gets incorporated into the rebel side, and so there you go.
Hmm.
Are you saying, Ian, that it got all usurped by Back to the Future today?
No, I don't know about that, but that's just what I've been seeing. I mean, I did see the Star Wars thing pop up when it came out. A couple days ago.
Are you asking if I'm excited about it?
Yeah, the Star Wars. Since you took us there.
Yeah, does it look good?
You watched it three times in a row, so I guess that's an indicator you're probably excited about it, right?
Well, okay.
You don't watch a trailer more than once unless you're excited about it.
Oh, hold on. I have a little man in the house, and things are different. You do things differently as a father because you're trying to, you know, build something. My dad took me to see Star Wars, and I'm going to take my son to see Star Wars.
Got it.
I expect to enjoy this Star Wars the way that I enjoyed the first, you know, A New Hope when I saw it in the movie theaters? Heck no. I mean, Star Wars was a groundbreaking movie in a way that was very, very special. But to my son Jack, this is going to be a big deal. And I'm not going to pretend for one single cynical second that I'm not going to enjoy this movie because I'm not going to take away from what's important to him.
Who's the director for this one?
Isn't Lucas the one who does these things?
No, I thought he sold all the rights from Disney.
Yeah, Lucasfilm sold everything to Disney.
Okay.
He's supposed to actually be like a much better director now that Lucas is out, but I can't remember who it is.
The whole plan for this movie came after Lucas's properties were sold to Disney.
Interesting.
Yeah, and that's also why you've been seeing a huge ramp up in advertising. Like, all of a sudden, Star Wars is on everything again.
I see. Well, we went to see the Fantastic Four movie this summer, my son and I, and actually my wife went along, too. He convinced her to go. And I thought the movie was okay until Dr. Doom shows up, and then it took a turn for the lame.
Oh, no.
I didn't think it was that great. But I wasn't going to walk out of the movie theater saying, "What a bunch of garbage. I can't believe what they did to the Fantastic Four." You know, you could afford to do that when you're single and you've paid your price and you're going online to get your opinion out there or whatever it is you're doing. You can afford to do that. But as a parent, I'm not going to ruin this movie for my son. And, you know, he's going to want to imitate. We got enough cynicism in the world,
yeah.
And he's going to learn that soon enough. I don't need to be handing it down to him. Thanks a lot, nerds. I do not need my son to hear all your cynicism. So I try to hide him from that, frankly.
I was just told on Periscope it's J.J. Abrams.
Yeah.
I've heard that name.
Actually could be pretty good. I liked the new Star Trek reboots. They were pretty good.
I thought they were really great, and the guy from Heroes who played Spock in it was epic.
Is this causing... Now, I didn't just... Till now, just realized that it was J.J. Abrams who did this. He's also known for Lost, the television series from the last decade, which is pretty good. But now you've got the same director of Star Trek and Star Wars. Is that going to cause like a fan explosion of anger or like fighting on the internet? Because, you know, haven't there been two very distinct fandoms of Star Trek and Star Wars, and now you've got like kind of a crossover?
There are, but it's not like they fight at Comic Cons or anything.
Well, no, not in the real world, but I mean on the internet.
They have their opinions as to which is better and which is worse, and they have their reasons for it. But, I mean, I wouldn't say that the rivalry reaches that of Red Sox and Yankees.
Okay.
I mean, you know, there's a bit of a rivalry, but you sort of know how things end at the end of your movie, and there's, you know, crossovers are rare if they exist at all. I'm sure some comic somewhere has made some crossover.
I remember George Takei, the guy that plays Sulu, was actually trying to get his fan base, because he's got like a giant Twitter fan base.
Yeah,
he's huge. To get him a role in the new Star Wars movie as a Jedi. So he was going to try to cross over. I don't know if he pulled it off, but it to show up as a cameo as a Jedi Master or whatever.
I guess you'll find out if you go see the movie. What is
That'd
it
be a huge
out in December?
Cameo to stick him in. Yeah.
When's it coming out, Mark? I saw the
December
trailer.
December 18th.
December 18th?
Oh, yeah. For Christmas. Okay.
So did you buy your tickets already, or are you going to wait till it's been open for a couple weeks before you take Jack, your son?
Well, you know, just that time is going to be very busy for us. Our pigs go to heaven on the 13th, and there's going to be some driving of cadavers around and things like that, and then getting meat back and all those things that are done in that time frame, and then we leave for Florida for a trip on I think it's December the 20th probably. So I'm thinking that what I'm going to try to do is
see it in Florida
on Christmas Day.
Oh, that's a good move.
You're gonna have to show up pretty early for that, I would think, right? Because don't a lot of people go see movies on Christmas Day?
If it doesn't work, we can go the day before or the day after, you know.
Well, the initial reports are that this movie has gone into, like, they've been selling tickets 2 months in advance.
Sure.
Which has never been done before, from what I understand. And, like, I don't know which site they crashed, but I heard they crashed either Movie Tickets or Fandango, which are the two main movie ticket selling sites with the insane amount of demand here. You know, you got to wonder, is this movie going to live up to the hype? I mean, there's so much hype, and that inevitably is going to bring expectations up.
Can any movie live up to that kind of hype?
The expectations are there already. I'm like, saying, will it live up to the hype puts the blame on the movie makers. Mm-hmm. You know, really where it lies is the reason people hate the first three movies, to some extent, I mean, they have all
the... By that, you mean the first three in the series, not the first three that came out in time.
Right. The second three of them.
The 90s movies.
Yeah. The reason they're upset, you know, to some extent, is that it doesn't reach the level of expectation that it did for them in the past. I mean, you know, for me, the first three were a big deal. I was young. We went to see them again in the theaters when they'd come out again. I mean, these were huge and epic. But how do you make a movie that's, you know, stands head and shoulders above other movies like those movies did? And you can't.
855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You're welcome to share your thoughts on Star Wars, the upcoming version, Episode 7. It's Free Talk Live.
Think you're fat? You might just be bloated. Find out by calling now for a free trial of Nubiotics, the new breakthrough that flattens bloated bellies fast. For a free trial, call 1-800-965-1170.
I used to be plagued by pot belly and constant bloating. After taking Nubiotics, my belly flattened and continues to get flatter. My sense of bloating and discomfort is gone.
If you've got a big belly, you might not be fat. You might just be bloated. Nubiotics is scientifically formulated with natural ingredients to flatten bloated bellies fast by cleansing pounds of rotting food and toxic sludge from your body. It even combats periodic heartburn and acid reflux. So just think how much better you'll look and feel. Think you might be bloated? Call now for a free trial of Nubiotics and see how much flatter it makes your belly. You might be surprised, but hurry, call now for details while these free trials last. 1-800-965-1170. That's 1-800-965-1170. 1-800-965-1170.
Do you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Then get on board with the Tax Admiral and let us steer your way to financial freedom.
The IRS is the largest collection agency in the world. They can freeze your bank accounts, seize your car, home, will garnish your paychecks and benefits.
Don't take on the IRS alone. I can fight for you using industry secrets that can help stop the IRS. I'll cut your penalties, slash your interest, and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company with over 30 years' experience helping people clean up their mess with the IRS. And we have a 90%
95% customer satisfaction rating.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS, are facing an audit, a lien, or levy, then call me right away.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Fact. The new NSA data center in Utah requires 1.7 million gallons of water every single day to operate. Billions of Fourth Amendment violations need massive computers and the water to cool them. That water is being supplied by the state of Utah. Fact. There's absolutely nothing in the Constitution which requires your state to help the feds violate your rights. Our message to Utah? Turn it off. No water equals no NSA data center. Visit offnow.org.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Star Wars, we were discussing the trailer. Actually, I initially had intended to talk about Back to the Future. It led into a discussion about Star Wars.
Star Wars just rolled over Back to the Future today.
Well, there needs to be another Back to the Future movie,
as far as I'm concerned. We'll get back to that, because I want to talk about that. That Ian's already starting to wear the same outfits as people in the future. Do you remember when he went to the future, how it was like punk outfits, but futurized? What a 1980s person thinks.
It's got to be really tough to figure out what people are going to be wearing in 20, 25, 30 years.
Well, you know, I'm no fashion expert, but isn't it true that fashion trends come back around? So it wouldn't be too hard to predict that something that has happened in the past is going to come back, right? Like, didn't bell bottoms have a resurgence at some point?
I have to cut in here because me and my girlfriend were talking about this. There really isn't a fashion style that I can label for 2000 to now. Like, if I showed you some pictures, you could be like, oh, that's 1960s, that's 1970s, you know, bell-bottoms, afros, hippie clothes. Even in the 90s, I could give you, you know, Kid and Play, like those crazy clocks or whatever. But I can't think of anything in 2000. If I said, okay, put a picture up and tell me what the last 15 years fashion was.
You'll be able to look back in another 15 years and be like, oh yeah, the aughts. That's definitely the aughts.
But what would
you can't
what
see it when
out?
You're in it. You can't.
How could you not tell when you were in disco that disco was going on?
Hold that thought. I want to go to Future Kid in Hill Valley, California.
All right, sorry, but we're getting back to this.
Future Kid, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello.
Hey guys, happy Back to the Future Day.
Hey, thanks. We're
sounds
at the
like
future.
Dave in New York. Go ahead, Future Kid.
I just want to say that there are no more Pepsi Perfect bottles. I called Pepsi corporate headquarters, and they told me that there was the limited edition of like 6,700 or whatever, and they will not be making any more Pepsi Perfect bottles.
What's a Pepsi Perfect bottle?
Catch us up. I don't remember that.
It was from the movie Back to the Future Part 2, and, you know, when you see him, you know, he's drinking the Pepsi and all that, whatever, there's a big thing about it, but I called, because today is Back to the Future Day, you know, 30 years ago, they went into the future, and here we are, but... And they were going to make, and they came out with only 6,700 Pepsi Perfect bottles. And I think it was only down toward in the city areas like Queens, Manhattan, Bronx, all that, you know, all the Comic Cons and stuff like that. And I was all over looking today, but you can only buy them on either Amazon.com or Walmart, and they all sold
They're
out.
Sold out.
They will not be making. They sold out. They will not be making any more.
I got to hand it to you, Dave. Future kid in Hill Valley. You've called with a really informative call tonight, and
that's good.
I thank you for it. This is like your best call that I can remember in a long time. So very good call. Thank you, Dave, a.k.a. Future Kid from Hill Valley, California. It's a true story. Here it is from CBSNews.com. Back to the Future fans across the country have been anxiously awaiting the date of October 21st. That's today, 2015. Since the 1989 sequel hit theaters, it meant the future would finally be here, which would include Pepsi Perfect.
Now, hold on. You know that on the internet, I kept seeing, today's the day that they Marty McFly went forward in time and whatever.
That's right.
I've been seeing it for so long. I've never seen Back to the Future 2, by the
Get
way.
Get out of here.
Never
what?
Seen it.
So you don't understand prison. All this.
I don't know that that's
1989?
The case. Maybe that's the case. Yeah. I don't know the answer.
You were in prison in 1989. Right.
The last movie I saw was Batman Returns, and before that it was Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure.
Okay.
So there you go.
Yeah, it's about the right time period.
Yeah, I mean, but what I've kept seeing it, so I didn't even know to believe this.
Oh, okay.
I saw enough hype that at some point or another, I'm like, oh yeah, must be the case. But I'd gotten to the point that I was jaded that this was the day that they bounced forward in the future.
Yeah, what happened was people started faking the meme like 6-7 years ago or something.
Yes.
So every year in October 21st, someone would
They'd
Photoshop
change the date
it
on
and
the, on the
change
meme.
It
from
and
the
so,
screenshot
and say,
from the movie where it showed the dates on the DeLorean.
And they would try to get a bunch of people to come to their Facebook page. And so it's been floating around so long that
but
when it really happened.
This is the real one.
Yeah, when the real one happened, nobody believed it.
So Michael J. Fox's character Marty McFly ordered the iconic drink at a cafe 80s in Back to the Future 2. To celebrate the future, Pepsi decided to make the famous soda a reality. Pepsi fans asked, and we heard them loud and clear, said Lou Arbiter, senior director of marketing for PepsiCo. He said that the Back to the Future trilogy was a big moment in pop culture history then, as it is now 30 years later. We're excited to be part of this moment to bring fans something only Pepsi could deliver. The beverage giant
Pepsi Perfect
did release 6,500 Pepsi Perfect bottles on Wednesday morning. These 16.9-ounce bottles contain Pepsi made with real sugar and were sold online at Amazon and Walmart for $20.15.
$20 each bottle?
For one bottle.
Wow.
$20.15. This is a collector's item.
Yeah,
right?
Clearly it is.
And of course, it's 2015, so that's where the price came from. Unfortunately, the company wasn't kidding when we said it would be a very limited run. Quote, we delivered on our promise to fans this morning, and Pepsi Perfect sold out faster than we can say, 1.2 gigawatts, said their spokesperson. Now, Back to the Future enthusiasts are blaming Pepsi for not being better prepared. Thanks, Pepsi, for ruining Back to the Future Day for many of us, one fan tweeted. Was really looking forward to owning a Pepsi Perfect after all these years. Thanks for ruining every fan's dream, another Twitter user agreed.
Ridiculous.
You could buy it for 5 times more on eBay.
You can. Some of the futuristic bottles are now selling for up to $500 on eBay.
The complaint here is that they made a limited edition run that didn't have enough editions.
That's the complaint. Yeah.
Oh geez. You know, this takes me back to working at the comic book store. From the time I was 12 to the time I was 18, I worked at a comic book store in Bradenton, Florida, near the county line. You know, like you could never make a fan happy. These grumpy people constantly complaining
Ridiculous.
About something. And, I guess I've just always been the sort of the Alleluia section of the choir. It's like, oh, wow, that's great that they did that. Oh,
yeah.
That's awesome.
That's a
they
cool
did
idea.
That. I guess it's just a personality type. I don't know, but
never satisfied. Some people are just never satisfied, and same thing's true
what
with these
Pepsi
sequels.
Pepsi hadn't made one at all.
Well, the same right. The same things. Yeah, exactly. Same thing's true of these sequels of these movies. You know, they try to serve the fans while at the same time making a movie that new people to the series can appreciate if they haven't seen all of the other movies, and that's a tough balance.
It's
act.
It's gotta be really hard
to do, and you're gonna piss off a lot of the fans if you don't serve them hard enough. But if you serve them too hard, then it gets too insider, and you know there's too many inside jokes or whatever, or references that are, just don't make sense to new people. So it's a really tough balancing act. You had one chance, Pepsi. Mm-hmm. This date only occurs once ever. You blew it, a film fan tweeted at the company.
Yeah.
Wow.
So there you go. Let's go.
Little grumper pusses.
Yeah, let's continue here.
Negative Nancy's.
We got James. He's in Dover, New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, James.
Hey, fellas.
Hey.
It's James, as you just said.
Yes.
Just calling in to give an update on the free Uber situation. I don't know if you've covered that in the last couple of nights.
We were intending to cover some of the news tonight, but since you wrote the story over at freekeen.com, why don't you tell us what's going on?
Yeah, sure. So kind of a newly emerging super activist out here on the Seacoast, Christopher David, who's actually a keynote speaker at Keenvention.
Yes, he is. He's the man who has pledged to do ongoing civil disobedience and keep giving people rides, even though the city of Portsmouth has made what he's doing illegal. And there's a development, and if you'll stand by, James, we'll let you tell the story. The toll-free number, if you want to join us, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. It's Free Talk Live.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't take on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st.
Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Silvio, rated an A-plus by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Tarrin Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. The latest about the Uber driver, the illegal Uber driver who's been on the streets, and he's not the only one. There are actually multiple Uber drivers now on the streets of Portsmouth, New Hampshire, in direct contradiction to the town laws, the town ordinances, if you will. We'll tell you more about that here in moments. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us, is 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. Mark, how does one receive Free Talk Live t-shirts?
Well, you got to pay for them, but you go to gear.freetalklive.com. We've got some awesome ones there. Go take a look. We've got ladies apparel, too, that was very important to our amplifiers who helped put this together, made sure that we, you know, they helped pick the designs, pick the logos, the font, and even the styles of shirts. So go to gear.freetalklive.com to check it out and see what appeals to you. It's gear.freetalklive.com.
We're on the line here with James Davis. He's one of the bloggers from the Seacoast over at freekeen.com. And I'm glad you're on board, James, because I've always wondered what's going on activism-wise on the Seacoast. And illegal Uber driver Christopher David has really made a splash in a big way with his free Uber activism, where he's openly violating city ordinance and giving people rides, people who want to go somewhere, who in some cases are drunk and should not be driving, giving people rides from point A to point B, and that is illegal. The town cabbies have been targeting the Uber drivers. They've been boxing them in on the roads. They, they're like preventing them from pulling away from the side of the road where they'll box them in. And they've been snitching on them to the police, and we've been waiting for the first ticket to be written against an Uber driver, and it has now happened. Is that what you were calling about tonight?
Yes, actually. So just this last weekend, there was a woman who's by the name of Stephanie Franz. She's 63 years old and a grandmother, supposedly, and she's a bus driver by trade, and she was just giving out Uber rides around 12:30 a.m. When she was pulled over and cited by a couple of different squad cars in Portsmouth. And Christopher David, who's leading the free Uber movement, happened to arrive on the scene, actually to pick up the very customers that were ejected from her her Uber ride.
She actually had customers with her at that time?
That's correct. Yes, she had customers in the car. The police kicked them out of the car and told them they were on their own. They said, we don't have any other ride. The taxis aren't returning our calls. And they were told, too bad, basically. So
sorry, lady. Hey, we don't care that it's cold outside. You're out on your own. Good luck getting home, you drunk girls.
It was pretty cold
exactly.
Last couple of days.
So they phoned. They just called their Uber. that's when Christopher showed up onto the scene. And it turned out that, yeah, this woman had been cited with a $500 summons. And she actually was also contacted Seacoast Online, which is interesting because that's typically a pretty lefty publication, and they covered her story in a really favorable light. They were essentially, you can check out the article at freekeen.com. I linked over to it. But
you've also got video of Christopher kind of arriving on the scene after the pullover.
The video doesn't show too much, but it does at least, it gets some context to the situation, and it does, you know, get him arriving on the scene and kind of catching her face for a moment. But it's really neat, and I think the reason I called actually was partially about this, but partially because of what we're seeing out here in terms of how people that aren't Free State Project movers have become emboldened to take a stand on this particular issue, because Uber's been attacked worldwide. I mean, you guys have covered that. And in many places, people have sort of rolled over and accepted it and, you know, been kind of grumpy. But, you know, Uber's not necessarily a product that people can't live without, right? So they aren't, like, out protesting, or they don't, you know, make a huge fuss. Their lives have basically been inconvenienced, and it's going to cost them some more money, but they don't really feel like they need to stick their necks out for these Uber drivers. And, of course, the taxi unions are so entrenched and paid off and all that sort of thing that they don't really they just don't make a big fuss out of it. But basically, it just took this one guy, Christopher, who was not really a front-and-center activist. I mean, he had moved for the FSP, I think, 6 or 7 years ago.
Yeah.
And just not done any real front-and-center activism at all. But when this thing affected him, he decided to take a stand on it. And the locals have really responded. You know, like you mentioned, there are still at least half a dozen Uber drivers out there on the streets in open violation of this law. People have been out helping us flyer all over Portsmouth, calling for the heads of the city councilors.
Now, just a quick question, James, to interrupt you here. You're a Free State Project early mover, as is Christopher David. And, of course, the Free State Project is the idea of liberty activists, libertarians, voluntarists coming to the same geographic area and getting active. And this is a great way for people to get active if they're out on the seacoast. But I'm curious, of the people who are going out and flyering and doing the, you know, the real activism to sort of back the Uber drivers, how many of them are the Uber drivers who are not libertarians, who are not Free State Project participants?
You know, I couldn't speak precisely to that. I would guess that it's almost all Free State Project people or friends of the FSP, you know, that we kind of, I don't know, activate by via social media or other contacts or whatever. But on the ground in Portsmouth, though, there are a lot of people who are really linking arms with the activists. You know, like, a lot of people have this perception that locals don't appreciate this sort of activism, especially, you know, open defiance of a public ordinance.
Some locals don't appreciate that sort of activism. I can tell you that.
Yeah, I mean, the cabbies don't.
The cabbies certainly don't. The bouncer at the club that snitched on Christopher David a couple weeks ago, he certainly doesn't.
No, they don't. But so there's this really prominent business owner. He owns a chain of restaurants called the Thirsty Moose, which are in Dover and Portsmouth and maybe other places too. And he also owns a t-shirt shop called I Like That in Portsmouth, you know, right there in downtown. And he's printed these custom run of free Uber t-shirts, you know, which Free Uber is what Christopher David calls his organization. And they're really cute, and people are buying them and wearing them around in Portsmouth.
Wow.
And, there's just a lot of energy here in the community around this particular piece of activism. And so, you know, people are getting excited. I don't know if you saw too, but there's a guy who's running for governor of New Hampshire, and he released his first campaign video. And in the video, he orders an Uber. He's like, you know, let's move New Hampshire into the 21st century. And then he looks down at his iPhone and he orders an Uber on his iPhone. And he says, "Do you want to come for a ride with me?" or something like that.
Neat. I don't know who this candidate is. Is it a Free Stater or just?
Well, I don't know if he's a Free Stater or not, but he is an A-rated Liberty rep by the NHLA. I did look that up. His name is Frank Edelblut, E-D-E-L-B-L-U-T.
Okay, fantastic.
And, good. Yeah, so there's this, like, critical mass of energy around this one little activist project, and I think for me it's just, like, you know, totally reaffirms the decision to move out here and get active, because you just never know what thing people are going to take and run with.
So yeah, that's true. And you know, had Christopher David not done this, you know, what would have the result have been? Had he not stepped up and said, "I'm willing to put my freedom on the line, I'm going to keep driving this Uber thing, you know, even if the police target me. And if the police target me, I've got an attorney already who's also a Free State Project participant. I've got an attorney already lined up. We're going to take this all the way." That level of commitment, I think, is what can inspire other people to take action. Because otherwise, you know, I don't know if you'd have people as willing to go around and flyer if it was just like, "Oh, we're trying to call the city council and beg them to do something different."
That's exactly it. And I think that one person being able to stick his neck out there, it's really inspiring for the rest of us.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's rallying the locals. And it's, again, it's emboldening these other people, these natives, like this bus driver woman. In the interview that she gives to Seacoast Online, you can tell she's just like, this older woman, she's not going to be told what to do. And maybe if no one else was posting flyers all over the town and saying, why is Uber being banned? And, you know, businesses have their flyers. Like, I noticed at least two businesses when I was in town the other weekend had these flyers, like, you know, giving away, like a coffee shop and this T-shirt shop right there on their countertop. Like, why is the city council targeting Uber, you know? If it weren't for basically one person's really big actions in that area, we would have rolled over. Portsmouth would have rolled over just like every other town.
Yeah, and Christopher David pointed something out, I think, on his Free Uber page on Facebook, and that is that, you know, this is super important for the entire state of New Hampshire, because the Portsmouth government is able to get away with this and continue to target Uber and shut them down, then that could be duplicated by other governments around New Hampshire. So if, you know, if the Liberty activists win this one, then that'll be a huge win for the entire state. There's another detail to this story. Do you want to stick around and talk about it? The threats against Chris?
Sure.
Yeah. All right. James Davis is with us here from freekeen.com. As a pioneer of the e-commerce movement, Overstock.com is proud to be the first major retailer to accept Bitcoin. Overstock was the first because Patrick Byrne, Overstock's CEO and founder, firmly believes in personal freedom and cryptocurrency. Over the past 16 years, Overstock has furnished over 18 million homes with a diverse line of products to suit everyone's unique styles and preferences. Support Overstock and freedom of choice while enjoying free shipping on orders of 0.211 Bitcoin or more. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com. Why are you playing a slot machine sound for an online poker site?
Do you have a poker sound effect? Because we have a new advertiser, swcpoker.eu.
Brought to you by the same guys that did seals with clubs.
Now they're called swcpoker.eu. It's Bitcoin Poker 2.0. They have lots of new games, including Chinese poker. The Krill leaderboard is active now. It's Bitcoin Poker from the brand you trust, swcpoker.eu.
Get on over to swcpoker.eu and start playing now.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us right here toll free. Our number, 855-450-FREE. The illegal Uber driver, Christopher David, is not the first person who has been ticketed for illegally driving for Uber, because he's not the only one on the roads. There are multiple Uber drivers still operating in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, picking up passengers, taking them where they want to go, and risking a $500 ticket. And that's the first ticket. It's my understanding the ticket cost will go up to $1,000 on the second offense. So Portsmouth city government is getting pretty serious about this, and the crackdown has begun. There are multiple taxi cab drivers out there who are actively snitching to the police about Uber drivers and their location. And now, after a few weeks, several weeks since the government outlawed Uber in town, basically, they didn't write a law specifically banning Uber. That would be illegal for them to do. But they did write a town ordinance that essentially bans them by requiring things that are ridiculous and making it so Uber's just not willing to go jump through those hoops legally.
Yeah, I mean, ridiculous or not, they're clearly protectionist notions in order to take old models of doing business like taxi cabs and outlaw new models like Uber. And you have to ask yourself, what if the candlestick makers had managed to get a hold of the machinations of government at the time that
outlaw electricity, you mean?
Light bulbs came around.
Well, hey, someone could hurt themselves with that electricity.
They're running electricity through tungsten in just a little bit of glass. It's going to burn everything down. That's what was happening, actually, at the time, is people predicted that electricity was going to cause, house fires.
And it did.
It did cause house fires, no doubt about it. But
so have candles.
So yeah, but back candles then, did too.
Back then, people wouldn't have tolerated too many laws either, though.
Yeah.
They didn't. They wouldn't put up with regulations, and it would be too hard to enforce.
James Davis is with us here. He's been really on the scene. He's actually gone out and participated in some of the free Uber activism, handing out flyers, posting flyers around town, promoting the idea of the free marketplace and allowing people who want to take rides from people who want to give rides to them. I mean, this is just such a basic human freedom, the freedom to travel. And the freedom to help someone else travel, because some people can't drive. They, for whatever reason, are infirmed. They can't get from point A to point B. They're too drunk to get from point A to point B, and they shouldn't be encouraged to drink and drive. But ultimately, banning Uber from town is going to encourage drunk driving, because it's my understanding, James, that a lot of the taxi cab companies won't even provide rides for people after midnight. Is that true? Do you know? Do we have James?
Like after midnight, but I know that I've seen just several places that negative reviews of all these taxi cab companies that they simply don't provide rides.
Yeah, I've heard they're just not available after certain times of night.
Yeah, that's right. And so, and Portsmouth actually had a really high profile drunk driving death in, I think it was August or something like that, too. So it's not like this is a foreign idea to the people out here that, people simply need rides home, especially during the summer months. Portsmouth, I think, doubles in population every weekend from travelers from Massachusetts and the South. I mean, it's a beautiful.
They're really great drivers too.
Hey.
Yeah.
So the other detail to this story that is developing as we speak. I mean, who knows who's going to be targeted next for this? The next detail is that there was a cop, the same cop who had confronted illegal Uber driver Christopher David, who's sort of heading up this whole free Uber thing. The cop confronted him about a weekend or so ago, and threatened him with ticketing him if he sees him on the road taking somebody for a ride. Chris himself has not been ticketed yet, but that same cop called him and told him today that he was thinking about charging him with wiretapping. Do you know more about that?
Yeah, so basically what the cop said was, I guess he knows this bouncer, which maybe speaks to your suspicion that this guy perhaps was an off-duty cop or ex-cop or something like that.
Yeah, the bouncer at a club.
So there's this character. He's actually the most intriguing character, I think, in the first video in this saga. If you haven't checked that out, it's over at freekeen.com, too. But he's the snitch and bouncer, which I just is descriptive. He's the guy who was bouncing outside of the Daniel Street Tavern in Portsmouth when Christopher shows up to give someone a ride home. And he takes time away from doing his job, bouncing at this tavern, to run over to a cop and tattletale on Christopher.
Hey, officer, there's an Uber over here. That's basically what we're talking about. I mean, you can hear it on the video.
Wow.
He starts by trying to do the cop's work for him in, like, the most classic. It just feels like you're watching a mafia movie or something. He's like, Uber, you can't drive around here no more.
Yeah, that's right.
You got to get out of here. You can't come around here no more. You know?
Yep.
And Christopher was like, okay, buddy. Sounds good. I'm going to just do it anyway. So anyway, this bouncer's reached out to the cop, and I guess he's going to try and pursue, I don't know, felony charges against
the cop claimed that this was a felony, and that's a lie. The cop does not know his own laws. They don't know his own statutes.
Well, we can only hope that he does that.
Well, didn't you guys already go through this in court that you can
record? Yes. Adamo Freeman from copblock.org was charged with felony wiretapping and convicted of felony wiretapping, which ultimately was overturned in the New Hampshire Supreme Court because he should not have been charged with felony wiretapping. I don't think he should have been charged with misdemeanor, but, you know, in their laws, it's not a felony, it's a misdemeanor. And let me explain why. The wiretapping charge that is a felony is if all parties to a conversation do not consent to the recording. Meaning that, let's say, Tarrin, you and Mark are on a phone call with one another, and I, by some sort of wiretapping method, am able to monitor your phone call. I record that conversation without the two of you knowing that I was recording it. I was not a party to the conversation, so therefore that's a felony. But if Christopher David, the Uber driver, is recording a conversation that he's having with a bouncer outside of the club, Christopher is one of the parties to the conversation.
He's part of the parties, right?
So therefore, not all parties have refused consent. One party did consent. That, by the New Hampshire ordinances or the New Hampshire statutes, is a misdemeanor charge. Although some are...
Well, even in that case, I'm not sure it's a misdemeanor charge because in this case, you know, there's no... expectation of privacy necessarily, right? When you're
there's nothing in the law that necessarily says that you should have an expectation of not being private when you're in public. It's a really bad law. The statute for wiretapping in New Hampshire is an absolute mess. And depending on your interpretation, there's an interpretation that says that yes, you shouldn't have an expectation of privacy in these conversations in public places, but there's going to be a strong argument that if the guy didn't see a recording device, that he had an expectation of privacy.
I thought Carla won that case in court, right?
That was with the police. This is with a bouncer
private.
outside of a club.
Well, you got to understand how these bouncers work, and probably what happened was, you know, bouncers usually have some sort of kickback system with the taxi drivers. If you guys didn't know that.
I've heard about that.
Well, yeah. I've seen taxi drivers in tire shops and mechanics places in that case. I had AAA Plus, which allowed you 100 miles of towing, and a tow company picks me up in my 76 Eldorado, which broke down on a pretty regular basis. And he's like, oh, man, I don't want to take you back to your home. You know, he complained about how far he had to take me. He was busy or whatever. And I'm like, all right, where do you want to take me? He takes me to a place. And then I watch the place give him a $20 bill for dropping me off there. I felt really ripped off.
Wow.
Yeah, that's messed up. And that's what I used to see in the clubs, at least when I used to work. That the bouncers would have something worked out with the taxi drivers because, you know, people come and be like, hey, what's a good club in town?
Yeah,
and
yeah.
That's where you go.
Well, this is what I didn't understand, I guess.
So that's why he's probably ratting it out.
To me because, right, like I just didn't understand why, you know, someone working in a private institution would ever just run off to the cops. Because
he's probably buddies with the and getting kickbacks from the taxi drivers. And the Uber guys aren't doing that.
Yeah.
That's as good a theory as any.
So yeah, James, he may be facing wiretapping charges. The guy, the cop on the phone claimed that he was going to talk to the bouncer and see if the bouncer wanted to press charges, which is also likely a lie because the cop doesn't have to talk to the bouncer to press charges. The cops can press charges on their own volition if they want to. So
this isn't law and order, right?
I suspect.
Away if you'd like to, for sure.
Yeah, there's no law and order involved here.
You know, having not heard the conversation between Chris and the police officer, my suspect is that this cop was on a information gathering phone call. He was trying to the cop was likely recording the call because it's legal for them to do it.
Oh yeah, they can do it.
And the cop was likely trying to get Christopher to admit that he had recorded someone, that he was the one who had created the recording that ultimately went online, which Chris has basically admitted on his Facebook while in public posts. But I think he probably wanted to get that information on the phone. That's my suspicion on this.
Yeah, I think so too. And I mean, it sounds like you know Chris a little bit, but he's not going to just roll over on any of this stuff. So
oh no! In fact, his attorney, who he has retained in advance, expecting that he's going to get one of these tickets for driving an Uber, his attorney is Brandon Ross, who is the same attorney who beat the felony wiretapping charges at the Supreme Court. So this he's got the right attorney in his corner in this case. And James, thanks for the detailed call about this. I'm glad we were able to cover it because both Tarrin and I actually had wanted to talk about this tonight. James Davis from freekeen.com, early mover for the Free State Project. Thanks for the call tonight. Hour number 3 is on the way. You can join us here. And of course, if he is brought up on wiretapping charges, we will certainly let you know about that. And Chris David is going to be speaking at Keenvention coming up here in just over 1 week from today. It's Free Talk Live. The new 4th edition of Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism, will take your understanding of liberty to a deeper level and has over 1,300 updated references, new cartoons, and a foreword by Dr. Ron Paul. With discounts for multiple book purchases, the 4th edition of Healing Our World is a great gift for the liberals, pragmatists, environmentalists, and Christians in your life who think libertarianism is cold-hearted. Get yours today at healing.freetalklive.com and use promo code FTL for a $5 discount.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Wednesday, gold is even at $1,174 per ounce, and silver is down 17 cents at $15.77 per ounce. Bitcoin is currently trading at $265. Check out our special on 1 ounce silver spiders, a perfect Halloween treat. And if you've been looking for silver American Eagles, we've lowered the price on those too. Give us a call today at 800-874-9760 or online at rrbi.co.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, October 21st, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.85 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,177 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $268. Antiwar.com reports fresh off his victory in the Canadian elections, Prime Minister-elect Justin Trudeau has confirmed speaking with President Obama and informing him that he would be going through with the campaign promise to withdraw warplanes from the U.S.-led war against the Islamic State. Canada had previously committed fighter jets to the war through March 2016, and while it's unclear the exact date of Trudeau's end, the suggestion is that it will be before that date. He did, however, say that trainers would stay in Iraq, but not the ground.
ground troops involved in combat missions. Trudeau has made ending the combat mission against the Islamic State a centerpiece of his campaign, and the Conservatives campaigned heavily against him on this point, including campaign videos using clips of the Islamic State propaganda videos interspersed with Trudeau's comments. Analysts see the election as, in large measure, a referendum on Canadian foreign policy, with outgoing Prime Minister Stephen Harper representing a more aggressive Canadian policy, eagerly participating in U.S.-led adventures the world over, while Trudeau favors a return to a more humanitarian focus. Revelations in recent months that Canadian warplanes were accused of killing dozens of civilians in Iraq and that the Defense Ministry had tried to cover those incidents up likely added to growing opposition to the war, and Trudeau seems to want to make it very clear that his promise to end it wasn't an empty campaign pledge, but a sincere statement of policy. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Wisconsin's Representative Paul Ryan reportedly told Republicans late Tuesday that he is willing to run for House Speaker as long as every caucus approves of him. Ryan, who has previously been mentioned as a potential Speaker candidate, accepted a recruiting pitch for the post by members of his party. Commentators and congressmen have both speculated for weeks as to Ryan's potential candidacy for the House's top leadership post, which will be officially vacated by Ohio Representative John Boehner on October 30th. Boehner, who has served for nearly 5 years in the post, announced his abrupt resignation almost a month ago. Ryan has earned a lot of political capital among congressional Republicans to succeed Boehner, but he has yet to formally announce his intentions to run. Tuesday, though, he agreed to meet with Tea Party hardliners who had strongly supported Boehner's removal and later a larger group of Republicans. Boehner announced he was stepping aside on September 25th. House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy of California, the House's top Republican leader after Boehner, remained in the race for 10 days, but abruptly dropped out on October 8th.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports a former Drug Enforcement Administration agent was sentenced to 78 months in prison on Monday for stealing bitcoins during the government's investigation of Silk Road and for secretly soliciting payments from the operator of the online black market for information on its probe. Carl Force admitted to charges of extortion, money laundering, and obstruction of justice. In a San Francisco federal court on Monday, U.S. District Judge Richard Seaborg said the scope of his betrayal was breathtaking. Silk Road operated for more than 2 years until it was shut down in October 2013. Ross Ulbricht, Silk Road's creator, who authorities say used the alias Dread Pirate Roberts, was sentenced to life in prison in May after a federal jury in Manhattan found him guilty of several charges, including distributing drugs through the internet. Prosecutors also reached a plea agreement with Sean Bridges, a former Secret Service agent, who was charged along with Force in March with stealing Bitcoin during the investigation that led to Ulbricht's conviction. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
When 16-year-old Jeffrey Patterson died in a car accident in February, he didn't just leave behind grieving friends and family, he also left a significant web presence. In a tribute to their son, Jeff's parents have continued to update their son's blogs and social media sites, including a blog called Shitbirds, Shitbirds Everywhere.
Well, Jeff used his blog to make fun of stupid shitbirds. Yeah. And now that we're doing this, it's like part of him is still alive.
Yeah, and then when I post a picture of some shitbird who has a stupid ankle tattoo or wears some retarded hat, I feel like somewhere he's smiling.
He hated retarded hats so much.
Whenever we get a comment calling Jeff a dumb fag for making fun of a handicapped person on a rascal scooter, well, it's like he's still here.
Jeff would have gotten such a kick out of that fat shit bird.
He really would have.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live, and Tarrin had to leave. He's still recovering from pneumonia. Seriously, I mean, you might have heard him coughing a little bit during the show, so he's had to cut out. But it's still Ian and Mark here with you.
Yeah, he was trying to stifle it, but you know, that's hard.
It is. It absolutely is. So, of course, you can join us here and talk about anything you want. We'll come back around to Back to the Future 2, which is like a huge social media thing happening today. We'll explain that a little bit further. And also, of course, you can bring up whatever happens to be on your mind. We're going to go right into your calls and thoughts. We'll start with Edward listening in Kentucky. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Edward.
Hey, good evening, gentlemen.
Hey.
Just staying on the same line as Uber real quick.
Yeah.
I heard a British cabbie over there, because I guess Uber has just won a victory over there in London. And
that's
so
right.
This guy says... I'm not just a cabbie for the city of London. I'm also an ambassador for the city. So he basically says, you get in my cab, and it's not just a GPS and monetized computer experience. And I just had to laugh.
Well, I agree with him. That's when I drove a cab, one of the reasons that the cab company would have me drive during the day and pick up the little old ladies on Longboat Key and drive them to the Sarasota airport was because I knew about, you know, which plays were in the theaters and which restaurants they should go to and these sorts of things. And so Absolutely, he could, he could very well be that. But
that presumes the Uber guys don't know those things.
It doesn't necessarily presume that at all.
Well, that's
he's just claiming that's what he is.
Well, right. This cabbie's trying to act like he's better than the Uber drivers.
Right. It's all fine and dandy until you try to get the government involved and keep somebody from competing.
That's the difference between you and him right there, Mark. He's getting ready to use the state to keep competition out of the marketplace.
Sure is.
That just makes him as bad as anybody out there, and it's definitely hypocritical, and it's pretty low, to say the least.
Absolutely.
Well, I think like in about 20, 30, it might not even take that long, but the generation is just going to be laughing at these people. You know, just
I agree.
The drug wars, and just it's really something. I don't know. I look forward to when this is just all done with, but I don't know when that's actually going to happen. But anyways, I was calling about, I'm down here in Louisville, and there's this scandal, in quotes, about the Louisville basketball coach. And have you all heard anything about
that?
No,
what's
not
going
at all.
On?
All
right, so it's been news for 2 weeks. So to get these Division One, this whole city revolves around basketball and all this jazz, you know, and I don't really keep up with sports anymore, but to get these players in there for college for 1-2 years, you know, they can't pay them on the books or whatever. So they get these guys in there, and this girl just wrote this tell-all book, and she's a exotic dancer slash, whatever else on top of that. And she got.
Are you suggesting that there might be sex in the champagne room?
Well, that's what her tell-all book says. Yeah,
okay.
It just got published. Yeah.
Well, now we know she's lying. So,
what was the allegation, though? What is the shocking tell-all?
Over 4 years that she was paid over $10,000 to come in with her dancers and for recruits and have sex with them and to dance with them and champagne and cannabis and whatever else. You know, these kids are 17, 18-year-old recruits that they bring in to play for a year before they go to the NBA, supposedly. So they're going to do whatever it takes to get these kids in. If they don't get them here at Louisville, they're going to go to Duke, or they're going to go to Oklahoma, or they're going to go somewhere else.
So this is a college team?
Yes.
It's a Division One college team.
Okay.
And the reason I comment on it is I'm a former Division One athlete, so I basically have been around the Division One experience. And
did you experience the
Division One the biggest?
Say again.
Is Division One the biggest?
Division One is the 100 and so many teams: Florida State, University of Florida, University of Texas.
Sounds like the biggest.
You know, it is the biggest. Yeah,
okay.
It's a monopoly, to say the least. and they're doing what they can to keep all the competition out.
So suffice it to say, you believe the story, right? That this was happening.
Regardless of not, but it's just this puritanical stance that the whole nation is taking, and a lot of people are saying that this girl should be in jail for
prostitution
prostitution or whatever,
drug dealing, sex with a minor, you know, like a whole bunch of things.
They weren't minors, though. She actually had, like, family members come in, and the youngest one was 17, and the legal age of consent in Kentucky is 16.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So there's no crimes on the books. It's basically, it's just this whole puritanical society where it's basically saying, well, you can't pay for this sex or whatever, but you still better have a winning team down here in Kentucky and Louisville, or if not, we'll ship you out. But they're basically saying, like, there's no way that the head coach knew anything about this. This is all just money off the books. And
who's doing it, though?
It's the assistant coach. The assistant coach, and they have his texts on file, which was just his main thing. He didn't get a drop phone or anything and just set this up.
I see.
To do it off the books or anything like that. So they have his texts, and he was an assistant coach, and he's moved on to a bigger, better job since then, and he's remained silent.
I guess he was successful then.
So wait, now what sparked this lady to write this story? Was it a book you said that she wrote?
It's a tell-all book. Yeah, it's called Breaking Cardinal Rules, and it's about it's basically about, you know, all about getting having sex with these recruits, 18-year-old, 19-year-old kids, 17, 18-year-old, 19. You know, a lot of these guys. Junior college transfers, 20, 21, whatever. I mean, definitely consenting adult males.
Yep.
So,
yeah, where's the shock? I mean, where's the controversy? I mean, I guess I understand why some prudes would be upset about this, but who cares? I mean, it's nobody's business what goes on.
Yeah, it's national news, and Rick Pitino, the head coach, he's getting ready to lose his job. He makes about $5 million a year.
And the claim is he didn't know about this? How could he not have known?
Well, they're saying it doesn't even matter if he knows or not, because they're saying the buck stops with you, and regardless if you knew or not, you've got assistant coaches underneath you, and if they're doing this underneath you, and
it's ridiculous.
I mean, there's no way that they're telling him every detail. He just says, ask so-and-so for the money, go out and do your thing, and I don't want to know about it, and get the players here, and we'll win a national championship. So, I mean, that's how college sports works, just because...
Yeah, this is probably not uncommon then, right? Like these kind of things likely go on at other schools.
Every school, absolutely every school. And it's a shame to see this. And the same thing with the Uber and all this stuff. I look forward to when the sex crimes, all this stuff is just decriminalized and we can just move on from all this.
There's a big push in, you know, college sports to pay college athletes. And, you know, the NCAA benefits off of these essentially unpaid
labor
students. Yeah. And
they're selling tickets to those games.
Yeah, they're very successful. It's just the only thing that eclipses it is professional sports.
Right.
It's right there. And this is just a sort of a function of that. The way you motivate people in the real world to do things is you give them perks. And, you know, those perks could be something besides money, but money's usually the big one. Maybe it's, dental,
sex
medical.
Sex with prostitutes.
Sex with prostitutes is something that maybe young men would buy with money if they were in a town that they're not in, you know, that they're not from or something like that. I hear young men have purchased sex with prostitutes in the past. So, you know, that could be it. This is just to get them to do it. And so if they'd let them offer paychecks, then they can buy their own hookers.
Edward, I'm with you, man. I want to see these ridiculous victimless crimes off the books as well. And I think that if we get enough liberty-minded people to move to New Hampshire, we can see that happen. We actually have, there's a state rep who is a Free State Project early mover. Her name's Elizabeth Edwards. She's actually elected as a Democrat. Most of the state reps that are Free Staters are Republican elected, but she's a Democrat elected and she's a Free Stater. And she's putting forth this year, for the first time that I think has happened in my memory of being here in New Hampshire, she's putting forth a sex work decriminalization bill. So it's starting to happen here. We'll see how that goes over its first time out. It's probably not going to pass its first time, but you never know. You don't know until you try. Thanks, Edward, for your call here tonight.
Have a great night,
yes,
guys.
Sir. If
have
you want to join night. The Free State Project and join the fun up here, because there's a lot of work to be done if you want to have more freedom. but we can get it done here if we get together as a group. Go to freestateproject.org, and this is Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-9358. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-9358. 1-800-944-9358.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then, too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
Negotiation isn't just something union leaders and sports agents do. Your entire day is a series of negotiations. If you have young children, you know that. In fact, your kids can teach you a lot about negotiating with grown-ups. According to the world's greatest negotiator, Herb Cohen, author of You Can Negotiate Anything. Herb says that kids understand the process of decision-making within an organization. When one parent says no, they'll ask the other. And Cohen says children persist and persevere. And like smart negotiators of all ages, kids know that no is an opening bargaining position. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
If you have a business, you know that IT can be frustrating, but it doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. Rootwork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability. Their nerds know business and can meet your needs. To prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions. Just go to rootwork.it/FTL to get your free call. That's rootwork.it/FTL.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited here to join us. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've talked about everything from glory holes to the Star Wars trailer and illegal Uber activism here tonight. It's Ian and Mark in the studio. And if you've got online shopping to do and you don't have Bitcoin, you should go to shop.freetalklive.com. You can shop through the Amazon links you'll find there, and Free Talk Live will get a portion of your purchase price when you do that. If you do have Bitcoin, then you should do your shopping at Amazon through save@purse.com. And you can link to all of those from shop.freetalklive.com. As we continue here, TJ is on the line calling from Missouri on Skype, actually. Hello, TJ.
Hey, has my audio quality better, Ian?
It's pretty good. It's definitely better than a phone call. So, yeah, go ahead.
Well, I just want to clarify something about Ademo and his appeal case that you said on the radio. His conviction was overturned because of a small technicality in the words willful versus purposeful. And in particular,
you're referring to a wiretapping case, right?
And the wiretapping in New Hampshire, it requires willfulness. In other words, you had to intend to record the other party without their consent, and you had to know that doing so was illegal. And that was the problem with the prosecution's case. They showed that Ademo had deliberately recorded the other party, but they didn't show that he knew at the time he made the recording that doing so was illegal.
Really? That's so why that case got overturned? I thought it was
Purposeful versus willful. And I'm looking at the case right here in front of me, and that's why I think it's good to just stress to all your listeners, never, 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 under any circumstances, talk to a police officer if they call you up. Convicted felon is just what you call an innocent person who was foolish enough to talk to the police. Mm. Because if they have any chance to misquote you, they will take it. And so, you know, that's why Christopher David, you know, the police officer calling, that is like a rattlesnake, you know, hissing its tail. They are getting ready to strike.
Yeah, oh yeah.
So, you know, he better not be talking to them, or he better be talking with his lawyer and not saying anything.
Christopher
because as
David
long as-
is the, for the listeners just tuning in, he's the illegal Uber driver that we've discussed quite a bit here on the program, who has continued to give people rides in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, even though it has been made illegal to do so in that city. And in my opinion, he's a hero for doing so. But the recent development is that a cop called him up and threatened him with wiretapping charges, saying that he was going to be asking the bouncer at a club that that Chris apparently recorded audio of their conversation, that bouncer may be interested in pressing wiretapping charges, which is a lie. I mean, the cop can press those charges if he darn well wants to. Do you agree with me, TJ, with my assessment that cop was calling to try to gather information that he could use to convict Christopher?
Yes. Yes, most likely. If you say, well, I know that you need two-party consent, but I don't care, I'm going to do whatever I please, that type of statement, you will sink your ship every time. I mean, it's almost a truism. Anyone who talks to the police will shoot themselves in the foot by saying something, however tiny, that, you know, they can pick and choose a quote what they say. And that's why any attorney will tell you, no, 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 never talk to the police. And that's one thing. When he was saying that he was talking to the police, I was going, oh, no, this is not good at all. I don't know what they're going to do, but you can be sure that something is cooking on the frying pan and it does not smell good.
Yep. You can go to YouTube and you can watch should I talk to the police? Just type that in and you will find you will find
yes.
Video after video after video of very intelligent, well-spoken attorneys saying, "No. Yeah.
I should have known better too. I should have known better, but I did it."
Yeah,
and
you went to jail because
I didn't go to jail over it, but I was charged with misdemeanors over it. And although arguably I probably would have been charged anyway, but it certainly didn't help me to talk to the police. And so even if you think you know your stuff, that you've got some experience with dealing with the cops, you're absolutely right, TJ. The littlest slip up, the littlest thing you say can certainly be used against you.
Yes. And I mean, you could even argue like Mark, but for the fact that he talked to the police, he would not be a convicted felon today because, of course, if I'm correct, Mark, you were charged with obstruction of justice. Was that the general gist of your charges?
No, it was what you're correct. If I would have gone to an attorney rather than talking to the police, that much is true. I wouldn't have gone to prison. But for me, I think that, I got charged with second degree murder. It would probably be more accurate to call me sort of an accessory or something like that. And I did get it finally released by the Florida Supreme Court. But it didn't have to do with charges. It had to do with sentencing. And so I just decided I didn't want to go fighting that battle. And, I was free. I don't need to spend any more money on lawyers.
But you, of course, you can definitely testify that it's always best to talk to your lawyer and then not let them talk to the police on your behalf, correct?
This is an important thing that sort of tripped me up is the police said, all right, call your attorney. And I didn't have an attorney to call, so I began talking to them
the
again.
Cops.
Now, that part makes the conversation I had with them, something that can be thrown out. It's, it's a piece of information that could have everything thrown out. I didn't know that at the time. And of course, you know, that's what they rely on, is people not having a lot of legal information. But yeah, even if you don't have an attorney, you can be like, okay, yeah, I'll get one at some point in the future. I'll see you later. Goodbye.
Correct. Always the best thing to do. So I just wanted to clarify that, because there was, you were talking about it. And so I thought, just that's all that I really needed to say. And so I'll let the next caller take my place.
Thank you, TJ. Appreciate that. The Skype username that you can connect to, by the way, if you want to do that, just like TJ did, Skype username is LRN.FM. You just send a contact request first. We'll approve it. And you're on our list. You're good to go calling from that point forward. We got Joseph on the line in Keene, our very own Keene, New Hampshire. Joseph, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hello, guys.
Hey.
I'm a member of the Keene chapter of Topless Migrant Transgender Uber Drivers for Open Carry and Sharia.
Thank you for your service.
We're trying to heighten awareness of the efficiencies to be gained through multi-special interest advocacy, and yet, you know, we seem to be meeting with resistance, even among the members of the communities we support.
Do you think it's the toplessness or the illegal immigration part?
Could be the transgender, it could be open carry, it could be the Sharia. We're not sure, but when you put them all together, it just seems not to be working too well. but it could be highly efficient.
I get it.
That's funny.
Absolutely, it's hilarious. I see the problems that might be inherent in this, believe me.
Yeah, all these people claim to be liberty lovers, but, you know, here we are, and, you know, just not getting supported. It's just not right.
It doesn't make any sense,
right,
does it?
Thanks, Joseph, for your call tonight. Appreciate it. Our toll
that call
number
was for you, by the way.
What do you mean by that?
There was a little lesson in that.
What are you suggesting, Mark?
That he's trying to tell you that perhaps, you know, that supporting all of the most fringe aspects of the ideas of liberty might have.
Are you saying it's fringe for people to go topless?
He was talking about topless, Sharia, open carry.
Is it fringe to support religious freedom?
What's that?
Is it fringe to support religious freedom? Is it fringe to defend yourself from people who are violent?
Just saying. That's all he's saying.
Are you saying there's a problem with open carry activism?
For me, open carry doesn't make a lot of sense. I wouldn't do it.
I've never done it either, but are you saying there's a problem with it?
Are there social consequences?
They do open carry litter pickups, and they're very, very popular. They get a lot of good response from people.
There's going to be consequences for whatever activism one does.
Yeah, that's true.
And, you know, pile it all together.
Is the complaint that activists in Keene have done a variety of different types of activism over the years? Because that's true.
Oh, I can
tell
you.
We're very busy here.
The activists in Keene wouldn't be supported by the folks in Keene anyway. I mean, generally, it's
a pretty
statist liberal place.
Well, that you just don't know what you're talking about, because there are all kinds of people who support us in Keene. Here's an email excerpt that I got today. You guys are doing God's work. I'm a lifelong NH native, and I love that you guys are so love free or die happy. Kudos.
So you've got to take a state construction license exam or certification. Can't decide on what books or what chapters to study? Discover right now how you can eliminate unnecessary books and wasted study time. At contractorexam.com, our study materials zero in on state-required test topics in an effective, multiple-choice format. So whether you're a plumber, electrician, general contractor, or other construction-related trade, contractorexam.com will help get you prepared. Visit us at www.contractorexam.com today.
A revolution in body protection has arrived, only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
Free Talk Live.
People, they like to complain about the idea that the money is taxpayer dollars. It's not really true, is it? I mean, they were your dollars until you gave them to the government.
Right.
Now they're their dollars, and they're going to do whatever the hell they damn well want to do with them.
You're right.
It is still your money, in that if a thief comes and steals money from you,
it doesn't cease to be yours just because they stole it.
You still have a claim on that, but you don't have the ability to control the thief unless you actually have him in your custody.
Mm.
So that thief is going to go out and buy a big screen TV or do whatever, you know, spend it on coke and whores or whatever it is that thieves do. with the money that they steal. And you
that's what the politicians
really,
do with it.
Yeah, you know, you can call the thief on the phone and say, I told you not to spend that money on whores. And he's going to say, well, thanks for the input. Yeah, noted.
I appreciate that.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.FM? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.FM. That's LRN.FM.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us right here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. It is Back to the Future today, basically. This has been all over social media today. The October 21st, 2015 date is apparently the date in the film that Marty McFly arrives from the past into what was, at that time, the future. In 1989, if that was when the movie came out, Back to the Future 2. We'll get a little bit more into what was their predictions. What were their predictions, and which ones came true, and which ones not so much?
I've seen the fashion pictures, and that clearly didn't happen. That guy's like wearing an iron on his head or something.
We can get into that, but you can also join us here as well. And don't forget, you can go to freetalklive.com to enjoy the features on the website. They're totally free, and the site itself has been redone. It's been given a facelift. It is version 3.0, freetalklive.com. Go and check it out. If you haven't been in a while, you get to create the content. That's still there on the front page. There's also now the Free Talk Live blog, where Mark is the new blogger there. You can click on FTL News. Mark, have you tried this yet? I heard that you didn't know how to get your own blog on freetalklive.com.
I'm still waiting for you to figure out when we're starting to. I'm writing these blogs and sort of when we're going to start premiering them.
Okay,
you know,
anytime you want.
Okay.
So go to freetalklive.com. Well,
didn't you want to talk about them on the show as we did them? I mean,
I don't know. Sure, if you want to.
Okay.
Go to freetalklive.com.
This shows how Free Talk Live's put together. It's just a mishmash of haphazard.
If you want to talk about one of your blogs, Mark, bring it in as show prep. FTL News is what you click on the front page. It's real big right next to our show topics or suggested show topics by you. And then I think you can comment on pretty much everything there as well. So go to freetalklive.com and check out the brand new website. Of course, everything there is still free. So if you want to download episodes, you want to listen live, you can do all of that. And it's all free at freetalklive.com. Mike is listening in Clackamas, Oregon. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Mike.
Hey, guys. Hey. Well, you... pretty much blew the topic I was going to talk about. I just got out of the movie theater, and I was watching Back to the Future, and I wanted to call in about that today because I kind of wanted to ask if anyone actually knew what the date was, but apparently everyone knows.
But, this has been all over social media. This whole October 21st thing is huge, at least in my feed.
Yeah, I figured, I'm like, I want to really go down to Universal Studios, the back lot, but tickets for that was like $880 for the whole kind of like week event or whatever. But so I did the next best thing, and I looked up in the movie theaters out here, which is down the street from where I live, if they were going to have to be playing it, and it was playing at 4:30, and that's the time that Doc and Marty arrived in the future.
So one showing, that's all they had was one showing?
I think they did that out of respect for the time that they actually arrived instead of an all-day thing, because if you look at the time circuits on the DeLorean in the second movie, they arrive at 4:29 p.m. In Hill Valley, California. So I think out of respect for just the details, the storyline, they did it at a 4:30 showing, and that was pretty much it. So I just got out of the movie theater just now, and I tell you, just seeing that, Michael J. Fox 30 years ago and Christopher Lloyd and all those people 30 years ago, I mean, it was awesome. I mean, it was incredible on the big screen.
Yeah, tell me about it. I mean, I knew they were going to do this. It's limited theaters that have offered Back to the Future 2 today in theatrical presentation for the first time in 25 years or 26 years, which is cool. I mean, that's really neat. I love
it when they
bring back the oldies like that. But unfortunately, there's not one within 40 miles of this studio, so we can't enjoy the same thing. Although I heard there might be an illegal showing in Keene anyway, so at somebody's place. But all that said, what was it like? Was it packed?
I wouldn't say it was packed. I think there were probably, I would say maybe about 100 people here. Which, I mean, it's a good size theater here, but I mean, it wasn't like, Straight Out of Compton. That was packed. But okay. I mean, there were probably about 100 people here. So, and everyone was into it when he was doing, Johnny B. Goode on stage and all that, and when the credits were rolling, everyone cheered and clapped. So, I mean, just the fact that date has finally reached us, I mean, I think that's what really made the impact and being able to see it. If they had showed the second one, it would have been more accurate because...
Wait, they didn't show the second one?
No, they showed the first one.
No, it was just the first one. It was just the first
one.
Oh. I was kind of confused on that, too, because the second one... they actually arrive at this date and time, not the first
one. Yep, but the first one was just supposedly a bigger, better movie. I don't know. I haven't seen both of them. I just saw the first one myself. I wonder how many people that you have to put in a movie theater at 4:30. Like the movie theater business, I don't know that much about it, but you got to get butts in seats, and obviously a certain amount of butts per day or at least per week in order to... do your business. So I wonder, is 100 people worth it or not worth it? Was it a waste of their time? I don't know.
No, because I've gone to movies, when I was living in New Hampshire, I've gone to movies where there's been one person in the theater besides myself, and that was it. They don't really make money on the tickets. They make money on the food, which is why it's against their policy to bring in outdoor food and drink, is because...
I've called movie theaters and asked if I could bring in food because I'm, generally not going to eat the stuff that they're serving there. Can I bring in some apples and some carrots and some, nuts and that sort of thing? And they're like, yeah, whatever.
Yeah, I mean, if you're straight up honest, like I asked to bring a Dunkin' Donuts coffee. There's a bottle of water at Dunkin' Donuts coffee. And they said, yeah, you're fine. Don't worry about that.
Wow. I could have sworn there were I think there are some theaters showing Back to the Future 2 today.
I'm sure there are.
Yeah, so maybe, is it like an independent theater that you went to?
No, it's a Century Theater, so I'm at it.
It's a chain.
They got like 10 or 12. Yeah, I think it's a chain.
Huh. All right. Well, Mike, thanks for sharing that. Anything else about your experience you want to get out tonight?
No, I just wanted to make sure I called into the show. I knew I couldn't do it, at the beginning of the show because I had to race down here because of the traffic, but I want to make sure I made this official announcement on your show, guys.
Yeah, it's the big movie today is Back to the Future Part 2 that has been re-shown in most of the theaters that are showing it Back to the Future today. That's what I'd seen advertised, and so you got lucky and you got to see the first one, I guess. Hey, thanks for the call, Mike. I appreciate hearing from you.
Another thing that I'm wondering about movies is, now that we're talking about movies and I'm sort of letting my mind wander about them, I recently saw the Fantastic Four movie with my son, and it was, you know, I didn't think it was that great. Once I thought it was fine until Dr. Doom showed up, and at that point I'm like, ugh, this just isn't doing it for me. He thought it was awesome. He's 7, you know, whatever, that this is one of his first experiences with Fantastic Four, and that's fine. Really irrelevant, but this was a pretty good kids movie, ultimately, is what I felt like it was until Dr. Doom showed up. And they ruined it by throwing in a couple of, and I'm not sure that they were S-bombs, or but a couple of wordy dirds, and I was like, you know, what was the point of that? And there's been a few movies.
It was PG-13, you said, right?
It was PG-13.
You kind of have to expect that in a PG-13 movie.
Yeah, I understand that. That's not what I'm claiming. Okay. And I don't, you know, I'm not saying, oh, they ripped me off. What I'm saying is,
why did they do it?
It's gratuitous.
Uh-huh.
And by that, I mean, it's like, you know, there's some times when dropping the S-bomb or the F-bomb makes perfectly good sense. That fine. That's okay to use that word. Okay. And then I thought in Avengers, when Captain America warns Iron Man, language, you know, like that was a good thing. And they, you know, ultimately it was fine. They worked it in and it was good. But there's sometimes when they'll just toss in an S or an F. And it's like, you know, you could have said something else here. And it wasn't, or not said nothing at all. Like, ultimately, like, whatever they said, it was just gratuitous. And I'm not trying to sound like a grumpy old parent here.
You do sound that way, but yeah, I get what you're coming from.
But I'm taking a 7-year-old to a movie, and I've seen this on, like, you know, there's YouTube channels where it just seems like they ruin perfectly good videos with S-bombs and F-bombs that have no value at all.
Our toll-free number tonight, if you can answer Mark's question, is your question why they do that?
Yeah, what's so valuable about this PG-13 thing that they had to have it? That's pretty obviously why they did it.
855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one multi-language solution for over 25 years, and satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Are your kids spending too much time online? Are they gaming instead of doing homework? Are they on Facebook instead of sleeping? Turn their internet access on or off when you want for free at webcurfew.com. 100% web-based interface means nothing to download, install, or configure. Webcurfew is free and controls any device using your home network without slowing down your internet. Block all adult web content with the click of a button. Don't let the internet raise your kids. Take back control of how and when your home internet is used for free. Visit webcurfew.com.
BodyArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's EATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
If you are successful at what you do, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, a business owner, or you have a great career, you understand the concept of protecting yourself. Well, are you protecting yourself, your family, and your assets with quality term life insurance? Consider these possible rates. A man age 45, non-tobacco user, could obtain $1 million of coverage for as little as $75 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 10 years. We specialize in policies of $500,000 and above. A man age 50, non-tobacco user, may be able to obtain $500,000 of coverage for as little as $115 a month. And this rate is fixed for the next 20 years. We have great rates for smokers, too. Call the Term Lifeline now. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403. 800-872-0403.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
BlakeDevelopment.net is a global leader in website creation, app development, and online marketing, catering to businesses of all sizes. There's really no job too big or too small for BlakeDevelopment.net. Do you have an idea for a killer app, but you don't know how to code it? Are you missing out on online sales? Or maybe your business needs help with social media. Websites start at just $200, and they're offering 3 years of free domain registry. Yes, they take Bitcoin. 844-SITE-123. BlakeDevelopment.net, 844-SITE-123.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Right now, you can call and join us here on the radio waves. The us includes me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And our toll-free number for you is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Skype username here is lrn.fm. Of course, today is Back to the Future Day, at least Back to the Future Part 2, where Marty McFly goes into the future. Of course, it was a direct continuation from Back to the Future Part 1. And it's been a long time since I've seen Back to the Future Part 2. I've certainly seen the first one a number of times. I don't really remember much about the third one. I think that it was in the West in the past. That's really all I remember from that one. Back to the Future Part 2 is, I think, also a fan favorite. There's a lot of really kind of memorable scenes in that movie, and it sort of did the reverse of the first movie, going into the future rather than the past. Great movie, and a lot of people
they foreshadowed that in the at the end of the first movie, is that the Doc had gone into the future, right?
Well, and then he comes back and picks him up. So it's not really foreshadowing, I guess, but foreshadowing is where something subtle happens earlier in the movie and kind of reveals itself later on. But
they alluded to it.
Yeah, allusion is sort of similar to foreshadowing. Right,
whatever.
But a great movie, and a lot of people had the opportunity to see it today in the theater. Apparently, 100+ people were in a movie theater in Oregon watching the original one. So it sounds like people were having really a lot of fun with this. And one of the things you can look at online over at Vox.com, we'll link to it on our Facebook and Twitter, is a list of the predictions from Back to the Future Part 2. Of what the future would be like, what 2015, where we are now, would be like. And of course, the movie has Marty McFly coming to the future on October 21st, which is today when we're doing this show. Vox.com has a little graph that they've set up with like two axes. So one axis, the x-axis, right to left, is wrong to right. And then the y-axis, the top to bottom, is understandable as far as the predictions that they made, and then outlandish. So in the wrong and understandable section, fax machines rule, where people are getting a lot of faxes in the future. Not so much. The Cubs winning the World Series. I guess that hasn't happened yet, huh?
Not yet.
Jaws 19. Nah, didn't make it that far. But we did have Sharknado, and Sharknado 2, 3, and 4, I think, is coming out. So there's still some shark movies out there. In the outlandish and wrong category.
I think that, but with Jaws 19, what they were trying to say is that there's going to be a lot of, what they're right about by saying Jaws 19 is there, the, you know, a lot of the movies, especially the big movies, they're just rehashes of old stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And that's kind of what they're trying to say. Clearly, they weren't trying to say there was going to be 19 Jaws movies.
Well, I think they might have been trying to say that, Mark, because at the time this movie was made, I think there were six or so Jaws movies that had come out.
There
were
quite a few. Yeah.
That's quite a few movies. And there have been a number of James Bond films. So it's certainly not unbelievable that a film series could go to 19 movies. In the wrong and outlandish category, so we had understandable and wrong first. Now this is the wrong and outlandish flying cars. Now, you know what? People are saying there are no flying cars, but there are actually companies out there who are developing and have been developing these things for years. They've existed for probably since before Back to the Future 2 came out.
If we were
going to
have flying cars, the government would have stopped it. Right? You know,
they basically, have stopped
they've
it,
stopped
basically.
It, yeah.
The Mahler Sky Car is one of the examples. You can go and research this. It exists. It's not within your reach. You can't buy one of these things.
I would like to point out, as far as the Cubs folks go, the Cubs haven't won the World Series, but they might do it this year. They're alive in the playoffs, and that's the first time this has happened in a very, very long time, much to the chagrin of the White Sox fans.
Dehydrated food is another one. In the movie, they have a tiny little pizza from Pizza Hut that they get out of a freezer or something. They pop it in some microwave device, some kind of
a box
hydrating device, and then it comes out of full-size pizza. That didn't happen. That was in the outlandish and wrong category. And lawyers banished from society, apparently.
How's that going to happen?
That didn't happen either.
The opposite has happened.
And it's been a while since I've seen the movie, so I don't remember that part of it. But it's funny because the producer of Back to the Future, Bob Gale, or one of the writers, I think he's also a writer, he actually also wrote and I think directed the movie Interstate 60, which also features lawyers becoming essentially screwed over.
Yeah, he hates
fun
them.
Theme. So here are the things they got right. We'll tell you that here in a moment. Let's go first to Vincent in Moultrie, Georgia. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. Hello, Vincent.
Yes, just real brief. You were talking about the Kentucky situation with the tell-all book and the
Prostitute has said that she was hired to have sex with and party with some recruits for a college football team there in Louisville.
Okay, you were calling it, I think you called this a victimless crime or something?
Yeah.
Or be.
Yeah, prostitution is a victimless crime by definition in that there are no victims, there's no complaining party.
Well, do you agree with that?
Oh, absolutely. What about you?
Oh, I certainly do not agree with it.
Where is the victim, sir?
The victim is in the people who participate in it.
Hold on a second. How can a voluntary consensual act involve a victim? Both parties consented to the act. It's not like she raped these college students.
Okay, it's very simple. This is it's called sexual immorality, fornicating. It's sin against God's word. So therefore, they are victims.
Okay.
Of this sinful act.
Well, God's pretty clear that man needs to have free will. And if man can't make a decision to sin, then he can't make a decision to be righteous. So, therefore, you know, the founding fathers were pretty clear on this, that, you know, we need to not institute a state religion, and thus, you know, fornication laws shouldn't be on the books. Wouldn't you agree?
Okay. In New Hampshire, there's a law saying you should not fornicate?
No. Not to my knowledge, no. I don't think he understood your question, Mark.
Okay. Do you want me to restate it?
Well, go ahead. Just
okay.
Try it again.
In order to sin, you must have the ability to sin, right? That's the fruit of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. You have to have free will. So if you can't have, if you don't have free will, you can't choose to sin. You can't choose to be righteous. So, you know, it's not a government's place to tell a person that they've got to be righteous, especially in the area where there's not a victim. The government's job is to protect you from other people, not to protect you from yourself. That's your job and the business of you and your God. So that's why we're saying it's a victimless crime. You can, for instance, kill yourself by eating too much sugar or something like that, you wouldn't suggest that we should do away, that we should outlaw all sugar consumption, would you?
Right. Okay. Agree with that.
There you go.
Okay, good. Well, so then you do agree that prostitution, while you may consider it a sin, is not a crime with a victim.
It is a sin, and it's, and there's a victim.
Are you saying a person can victimize themselves? I mean, the word victim has a very specific meaning, right? I've got the dictionary pulled up here. It's a person who suffers from a destructive or injurious action or agency, and typically not at their own consent. I mean, you could argue that somebody who is a masochist likes to be victimized. But generally, victims are people who don't consent to things that are done to them. So if I shoot you, Vincent, then you would be a victim, right?
Yeah.
Okay. But if you shoot yourself, have you then victimized yourself?
Well, I victimized myself with a bunch of pain and suffering.
Well,
you've certainly inflicted that upon yourself.
You're not looking for anti-masturbation laws, are you? Because I mean, I'm pretty sure that most Christians would say that onanism is against the law, is against God's wishes or whatever. And so, if you know, by this definition, if two people can't participate in consensual sexual acts, then one person shouldn't be able to participate in consensual sexual acts, right?
Sounds like you've got a lot to think about.
It's a matter of that free will.
Indeed it is.
We'll leave it at this, Vincent. Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Sounds like you gave him a few things to think about there, Mark, and that's a good thing.
Yeah, free will is what it comes down to.
All right, so more on Back to the Future. What is it that they got right with their predictions? Here's the understandable and right category. Video chat. They got that one. That's here. Video glasses.
I think Jetsons did that too. All right.
That's here. Cars that use alternative fuel. That's happening. And then here's the section of their chart that is what they got right and outlandish. Hoverboards, they just happened this year in 2015. The
Lexus, they're not hovering, right?
Haven't you seen the video, the Lexus hoverboard?
No, I guess I haven't.
You should pull that up. Thumbprints as keys, we've got that. People are locking their phones with their thumbprints. And CGI dead celebrities, we've got that too. Like Tupac, the Tupac hologram. We'll see you tomorrow night.
Freddie Mercury.
Online in the meantime. Hoverboard, it's pretty early technology, Mark, but it's happening. Check that out. It's Free Talk Live. See you tomorrow.
Blake
Keenvention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, The Seditious Sirens, The Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, Tech Guru Brian Sovereign, Cop Blocker J.P. Freeman, New Mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand Minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallokeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Wednesday, gold is even at $1,174 per ounce, and silver is down 17 cents at $15.77 per ounce. Bitcoin is currently trading at $265. Check out our special on 1 ounce silver spiders, a perfect Halloween treat. And if you've been looking for silver American Eagles, we've lowered the price on those too. Give us a call today at 800-874-9760 or online at rrbi.co.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Cop Block Radio is up next, live after the news, on the Liberty Radio Network.
LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Wednesday, October 21st, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.85 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,177 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $268. Antiwar.com reports, fresh off his victory in the Canadian elections, Prime Minister-elect Justin Trudeau has confirmed speaking with President Obama and informing him that he would be going through with the campaign promise to withdraw warplanes from the U.S.-led war against the Islamic State. Canada had previously committed fighter jets to the war through March 2016, and while it's unclear the exact date of Trudeau's end, the suggestion is that it will be before that date. He did, however, say that trainers would stay in Iraq, but not the ground troops involved in combat missions. Trudeau has made ending the combat mission against the Islamic State a centerpiece of his campaign, and the Conservatives campaigned heavily against him on this point, including campaign videos using clips of the Islamic State propaganda videos interspersed with Trudeau's comments. Analysts see the election as, in large measure, a referendum on Canadian foreign policy, with outgoing Prime Minister Stephen Harper representing a more aggressive Canadian policy, eagerly participating in U.S.-led adventures the world over, while Trudeau favors a return to a more humanitarian focus. Revelations in recent months that Canadian warplanes were accused of killing dozens of civilians in Iraq and that the Defense Ministry had tried to cover those incidents up likely added to growing opposition to the war, and Trudeau seems to want to make it very clear that his promise to end it wasn't an empty campaign pledge, but a sincere statement of policy. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Bitcoin Not Bombs. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. UPI reports Wisconsin's Representative Paul Ryan reportedly told Republicans late Tuesday that he is willing to run for House Speaker as long as every caucus approves of him. Ryan, who has previously been mentioned as a potential Speaker candidate, accepted a recruiting pitch for the post by members of his party. Commentators and congressmen have both speculated for weeks as to Ryan's potential candidacy for the House's top leadership post, which will be officially vacated by Ohio Representative John Boehner on October 30th. Boehner, who has served for nearly 5 years in the post, announced his abrupt resignation almost a month ago. Ryan has earned a lot of political capital among congressional Republicans to succeed Boehner, but he has yet to formally announce his intentions to run. Tuesday, though, he agreed to meet with Tea Party hardliners who had strongly supported Boehner's removal and later a larger group of Republicans. Boehner announced he was stepping aside on September 25th. House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy of California, the House's top Republican leader after Boehner, remained in the race for 10 days, but abruptly dropped out on October 8th.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270.